Queenslanders are such good golfers?
Ooh, no.
No? Why? Because they have plenty of things to practice hitting. Four!
I was cleaning behind my fridge the other day, you know what I saw? What? The New South Wales back line in a practice session.
New South Wales. Queensland. It's war. Origin football, the pinnacle of rugby league, and the game's greatest showpiece. Nothing hits harder. Nothing moves faster.
O'Connor, every time he touches, there's a bit of magic with O'Connor.
Nothing can match the emotion of State of Origin. Yes, it's New South Wales versus Queensland in the fastest, most ferocious football battle on earth. Leading the Queensland charge is Captain Marvel, Mighty Mal Meninga. Skippering the Blues in 92 is Canberra's live wire champion, Laurie Daly. Following the Daily Express into battle is Kangaroo Lock Bradley Clyde. With support from the extraterrestrial talent of Andrew E.T. Ettinghausen and the entire Blues Brigade. For Queensland, the artful dodger Alfie Langer is set to weave his spell. And the magic man, Peter Action Jackson, is back. Along with a cast of kangaroo heroes spearheaded by the great Bob Linder. So pull on your flak jackets, shore up the defences and break out your state banner. Round one of football's most famous feud.
Players coming in from all over now.
It's a state of conflict.
Well, he's only been on a few seconds.
State of mayhem.
And the State of Origin has erupted again.
State of war. State of Origin 92.
You are watching, ladies and gentlemen, scenes from the Sydney Football Stadium, the venue for tonight's first Winfield State of Origin match between Queensland and New South Wales. We welcome viewers through QTQ9 Brisbane and the Win Television Network. Good evening, everyone. I'm Allan Thomas, and Andrew Slack, the build-up for these matches, it just keeps getting better and better.
It does, of course, and after some 30 games starting since 1980, Wally Lewis has had a lot to do with that build-up. Of course, 1992 sees a Lewis-less State of Origin series, and I guess just for that factor, it creates more interest even still.
It certainly has in the media down here. They've had a lot to write about the non-Wally factor, but they might have to worry about a Mal Meninga factor tonight.
And plenty of other factors. I think a lot of things have been spoken about, the front row clash, the perhaps lack of fitness and form of a couple. Also, the Walters versus Daly 5/8 clash. The one I find particularly interesting, out on the wings. For a change, New South Wales have picked a couple of wingers on the wing, Wishart and Mackay, but they're playing a couple of the best in the world, I'd say, Michael Hancock and Willie Kahn. If those opportunities are created up front, Queensland have two great finishes.
Queensland a win by how much?
I'll be half a dozen in it, maybe.
I'm going the same way, Queensland by six.
Well, a couple of pretty confident Queenslanders over there, Greg Dowling.
Yeah, there certainly are. There's a few Queenslanders supporting the side here tonight, so that'll be great.
Actually, I've spoken to a couple of New South Welshmen too, and you have also a couple of ex-Test players that think the same.
Yeah, they do. It's not all one-way traffic here today.
All right, we'll talk about that just a little bit later, but what we might do now is talk about the weather, and there's plenty to talk about. It's outstanding. Temperature at the moment around about the 15-degree mark. Few clouds about early this afternoon, but it's a great night and far better than some of the nights you've been out here, GD.
No, that's right, Billy. It's usually raining down here, but this one the first time that it's been fine. So it should set the stage for a great battle.
All righty, crowd starting to move in. They expect a capacity crowd of 40,000 here tonight. And there's one thing about this ground, when it's full like that, the atmosphere's outstanding. But quarter full, it's pretty diabolical.
Yeah, it certainly is. It's just from one extreme to the other. When there's only a few people here, you just don't want to play. It's that empty, hollow feeling, and the play drops.
All right, what would those fellas be like out the back there now?
They'd be pretty nervous at the moment, going through, getting the last drink of water, geeing each other up. And if it was like any days when I was playing, you just can't wait to get out in the paddock and get it over and done with.
All right, there's talking about out on the paddock, there's going to be some very interesting clashes out there tonight. Let's take the head-to-head with Darryl Eastlake.
Fullbacks, Andrew Ettinghausen against Dale Shearer. On the wings, Rod Wishart and Michael Hancock, the other Graham Mackay and Willie Kahn. In the centres, Brad Fittler faces Peter Jackson. And debutant Paul McGregor marking the origin master and most experienced player in the game, Mal Meninga. His opposing captain will be clubmate Laurie Daly.
He's a great friend of mine and we get on extremely well. And I think that he's going to do a great job captaining New South Wales side. He's a player that leads by example, and I've got no doubt in the future sometime he's going to captain Australia.
Mal's an inspirational player, and to have played under him after, you know, for the last couple of years, he certainly does lead by example, and I'll be trying to do that with the Blues.
Daly against old teammate Kevin Walters. The halves, 19-year-old rookie John Simon faces up to Allan Langer. The locks, Bradley Clyde and Gary Larson. Second row, Paul Sirenen matched against Bob Lindner. The other pair, John Cartwright and the Axeman, Trevor Gilmeister, also charged with containing clubmate Glenn Lazarus.
Oh, he's got another blue jersey on, mate, and once you're out there playing, you play your normal game. Don't hold back.
We're all very professional players. We know that there's Australian jumpers up for grabs in the course of the series, you know, and yeah, we'll all go in as hard as possible, but I'm sure after the game we'll all have a beer together.
Glenn Lazarus fronts Steve Jackson. And newcomer Paul Harrigan on inspection against Martin Bella. In the hooking roles, Ben Elias and Steve Walters. On the bench for the Blues, Craig Salvatori, Brad Mackay, Rob McCormick and David Gillespie. The Maroons, Gary and Mark Coyne, Steve Renoff and Gavin Allen.
Well, the Sydney Football Stadium in darkness at the moment as they get ready for some of this pre-match entertainment. But, GD, we were talking about the dressing room. Let's have a look at that Queensland room now, eh? Let's see what's happening in there. I guess it'll be pretty tense. There's Big Mal getting ready for what should be a great night for him as captain of the side for the first time.
Yes, expect a big game from Mal. He's taken over from Wally as skipper, and it's very tense in that dressing room at the moment. Here we have Steve Renouf stretching up.
Well, he had one run last year, and he's certainly kept the form going very well this year, and we'll see a bit of him a little bit later. There's Steve Jackson. Now, he's got to be one of the question marks, I guess.
Yes, a lot's going to be asked of him tonight. He hasn't played for 2 weeks with injury, so he'll have to lift himself tonight.
And as we move around the room, Trevor Gilmeister, well, the axe is in outstanding form at the moment. We'll look for him to be getting into Cartwright and company tonight.
Yes, he's waited for a long time to get back into this Queensland side, and he'll be going out there to prove a point tonight.
All right, and as we move across the room, who do we see? The coach, Graham Lowe, sitting there on his lonesome. I hope it's not going to be like that at the end of the match.
No, it certainly won't. I expect him to be sitting there surrounded by the media, basking in the glory.
All right, we might take a break. Be back here very shortly at the Sydney Football Stadium. Welcome back to the Sydney Football Stadium. And as you can see, the excitement is really building up, all right. The on-field entertainment taking place out there at the moment. I'm not sure of the band, but by the theme, they should be hunters and collectors, because there's plenty out there, and I notice a big pot. Someone's going to get bored a little bit later on. Not quite sure who it will be, but I'm sure it's going to be a Queenslander somewhere along the line. Okay, when we talk of state of origin, we go back to when the series first began in 1980. Young bloke by name of Walter Lewis was running around on that occasion, and up until the end of the last series last year, he virtually dominated state of origin from a Queensland and New South Wales point of view. So let's have a look now at some of the Wally years.
But here's Wally Lewis with a stolen ball now. Lewis makes his way upfield. He's got some pace. Lewis, can he go it away? Still down, he does so. Wally Lewis has gone in, and look at this.
Unforgettable. That's what you are.
Unforgettable.
sound.
Wally Lewis has got underneath for another try. Tedescu inside for Bob Fleet, one tackle. He's got Lewis with him. And Lewis scores. Kenny getting a lovely short pass away to Michael O'Connor. A step. Oh, look at the last tackle from Lewis.
Lewis, a little chip. Oh, it bounces off the upright. Still lay right away. This is Wally Lewis. He's in. Oh, Lewis is in again. He's got it. He's got it around the outside, and he's gone. And the crowd go mad. Tedescu, there's the halftime hurdle. Lewis will take a drop shot for goal. It's high.
That's right.
And it's there. Lewis has done it again.
It's incredible.
And Wally's got five.
Here come Queensland now. Lewis, it's a pass. He's in! And he
unforgettable.
Football's been my life. You just don't get games like that out of your blood. I mean, it's too hard. It's my first love, and it'll probably be my last love.
And I wonder whether Queensland football will ever get Wally Lewis out of their blood, Andrew Slack.
Well, unforgettable indeed, but I guess they'd like Lennon and McCartney to get in on the act with yesterday, or Mal Meninga would, because that was yesterday, and he's more interested in May 6, 1992, as we watch the band continue their antics. And Mal Meninga has said that the team has got to forget about Wally. He's no longer there, and it's extremely important that they play well without him. That's the New South Wales dressing room, and they're looking reasonably relaxed, going through the obvious normal pre-match routine, the strapping and the rubbing and all the things that the players want to get out of the way so they can get back onto that paddock and belt out their frustrations or their joys, whatever will unfold later in the evening. There's, of course, Benny Elias, the vice-captain of the side, up, very keen to be captain. Laurie Daly got that job. Elias leading the forwards. John Simon, a lot on his shoulder. Craig Salvatori and John Cartwright, they'll be very important men.
We'll take a commercial break, then be back at the Sydney Football Stadium.
And welcome back to the Sydney Football Stadium. There's the scene of the crowd. They've really built up over the last 15 minutes or so. They seem to arrive just on time. They're taking down the band. They were the screaming Jets. They were certainly screaming, GD, as they went through their bits before.
Yeah, they were, but it's got the crowd fired up. It was great entertainment before the game.
All right, you've played 10 State of Origins. New South Wales lacking a bit. As a matter of fact, there's four guys in the run-on team tonight that don't have experience of State of Origin. Very briefly, what's it mean?
Well, that's why I tend to go for Queensland, just on the fact that Queensland have got more experience there. And you do get found wanting out here. Over the years, Queensland have only, you know, changed one or two players over the years. That's why they are so far in front on the head-to-head.
All right, let's have a look at those rookies now. Four of them stepping out tonight. Five overall. Here they are with Ken Sutcliffe.
Over the past decade, it's been stability that has played such a major role in Queensland's preparation for the series. But once again, the Blues will debut new players. Paul Harrigan, the young giant who tore the heart out of Sydney, up against the seasoned Queensland warhorse, Marty Bella.
Probably the most inexperienced in him probably would be the experience, but I think you live in no one's shadow when you're out there in the game, and I think the crowd and, mate, just to play with New South Wales, I think it'll eradicate that, and it'll just be me and him, and it should be good.
Paul McGregor has the speed and size to equal Mal Meninga and Peter Jackson. Mild in manner, he's big on action.
Just go out there and try to do my best against such two great footballers and hopefully equal them and maybe get on top.
John Simon, A stepper with a big kicking game finds himself the toughest of assignments to keep Queensland's main striker, Allan Langer, in check.
I've just got to do, you know, the job I do with Illawarra. You know, just sort of call the shots, you know, get him going here, get him going forward, you know, and then just let it sail for Illawarra and the rest of the backs.
Graham Mackay, a powerhouse down the touchline, but also ready to roll up his sleeves and pitch in to help the forwards in the hard stuff.
Oh, mainly probably from the start, just help out the forwards, like be pretty tough in the middle, just get in there and get involved from the start.
Robbie McCormack, Mr. Versatile, a player who can't wait to get into the fray. The little knight may just be the player to turn the tide if the Blues run into trouble.
I'd like to get out there straight away and get into it, but watching the other guys run around and just see how the game's running out, that's an added bonus.
Tomorrow on A Current Affair, Australia's youngest blues sensation.
Could be the next Eric Clapton.
Couldn't ask for anything better.
On tour with music's big boys.
I said, oh, well, you know, you're on pretty soon. He said, what, am I on first?
Tomorrow, 6:30 on 9.
At last, Noosa Waters are proud to announce the release of their newest and most exciting waterfront land from only $135,000. That's right, now from only $135,000. Waterfront land in Noosa is becoming very rare and prices are expected to rise 20% over the next 12 to 18 months. Hurry, Noosa Waters' latest land release will not last at these prices. Noosa Waters.
I like it when Mum lets my friends stay over.
Reward your mum at KFC from now till Mother's Day.
I like it when Mum's not home.
With the Mum's Reward Pack, 16 pieces of chicken plus a free Sara Lee Black Forest cake to show Mum you think she's great.
A free Sara Lee Black Forest cake for Mum?
And I like it like that.
Okay, I do like it when she's home.
Mum's Reward, 16 pieces and a free Sara Lee Black Forest cake.
I like it like that.
Everything else is just hot air.
They offered me $450. I said, hang on. It's got a motor, so they bumped it up to $600.
When Big John Zupp says he'll trade any old iron, he means it. Bring in your trade to any Zupp's used car yard and clean up a bargain.
Philips' new range of natural colour, large screen televisions bring pictures to life. The same technology has also been applied to the sound quality. Philips Symphobass Hi-Fi system brings you another step closer to the ultimate home cinema sound experience.
Philips, take a closer look.
For the reward of a smart rate term deposit with an interest rate that can rise but never fall below a preset minimum. For the reputation of Metway Bank's friendly staff who'll help you make some smart decisions of your own. For whatever reason, there is no other bank like Metway Bank. You've never had a better reason to change.
For the action, for the excitement, for whatever reason, Metway Bank hopes you enjoy this State of Origin.
And welcome back to the Sydney Football Stadium. Countdown time. The seconds tick over. The teams about to come out to do battle in the first Winfield State of Origin match for 1992. New South Wales favourite with the bookmakers, as per usual. And all the tension, all the lead-up, Andrew Slack, all the training sessions, they now mean nothing. If the schoolwork hasn't been done,
ladies,
it's too late.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the Sydney
As we see the New South Wales team coming down that tunnel, led for the first time in his career by that whiz kid from Canberra, 22-year-old Laurie Daly.
The experience of Elias trying to calm the nerves, no doubt, in Daly. And he'll get a big cheer when he comes through the tunnel. They love him here. They stand for the New South Wales side. The challengers to the Queensland throne.
Say about an hour ago, and they're sitting watching that early match. The New South Wales team very, very stern. The Queensland team totally relaxed, absolutely relaxed.
Can sometimes be a good thing or a bad thing. but I don't think that if things start badly for Queensland, that Malcolm Meninga will let any composure turn into complacency. Peter Jackson and Mal Meninga, the experienced centre pairing. Daly moved in from the centre into 5-8. A lot of people think he'd be more valuable out wide in that one-on-one confrontation.
So these are the backs for New South Wales. Ettinghausen, Wishart, Mackay, the wingers, McGregor and Fittler in the centres. Daly at 5-8. And the 19-year-old John Simon wears the number 7 for New South Wales.
What?
Their pack, Bradley Clyde at the back. A big second row in Paul Siren and John Cartwright, and a strong front row, Glenn Lazarus and Paul Harrigan with Ben Elias.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please...
We'll have a look at the Queensland backs. Dale Shearer, of course, back at the fullback posse. He's a veteran of State of Origin. Hancock and Carr on the wings, and they go on from there. Larson, Gilmeister, Lindner, Bella, Jackson and Walters. Pretty good pack.
We'll stand by now for the national anthem. One thing both teams have in common, Andrew Slack, is the anthem. Now that's it.
That's the end of it for sure. And Paul Harrigan, we see loosening up Glenn Lazarus, the front row pairing for New South Wales.
So this is it, of course, as we said, it's mate against mate, club mate against club mate. Now there's a man in charge tonight, Dave Manson, has refereed 4 State of Origin matches so far, and he gets the nod for this opening encounter tonight here at the Sydney Football Stadium.
Man in charge last year, of course, with that famous dust-up, shall we call it, between Wally Lewis and Mark Geyer. David Manson just about to signal the kickoff.
And John Simon starts the State of Origin series. Langer and he's in goal. And the captain, the big fella, runs it out, Mal Meninga. He's about 18 out from his own line and gets the first penalty of the match.
Well, we've talked about it all year that the referees have been very strict around the play the ball, holding the tackled player down. And first seconds of the match, he's done exactly that, David Manson. Penalised John Cartwright and Glenn Lazarus for holding Meninga down. Penalty to Queensland will get them out of their 22. Peter Jackson kicking for the line.
He finds it. Just outside the quarter, Martin Bella. Oh, the swinging arm from Cartwright. Cartwright with a looping left hand. Now Jackson. And he's popped the ball up and they've made a mess of it. Larson wasn't watching, wasn't expecting the ball. So New South Wales have possession. And they're about 32 metres out from the Queensland line. Elias goes to dummy half. Over to Harrigan. Oh, he's hit over the top by Gilmister, and underneath was Larson. And he's hurt. I'm just wondering whether that knee's not standing up already. He's holding the left knee, Harrigan. Here's Daly cutting inside. Harrigan's knee was gone after the Broncos-Newcastle match. It was doubtful whether he's going to be selected, and he's feeling it already. New South Wales outside the Queensland quarter. It's where Lazarus will play it to Elias. Now Simon sits up for Shearer. And he's met in stern defence by Fittler. Also Sirenen and Simon did the chasing. Linder from dummy half. New South Wales plan, obviously, to keep Queensland in their own 22. Gilmister ran it out of there. In with his clubmate, Glenn Lazarus. He's Broncos' clubmate, and the little fella goes to ground. Jackson trying to hit it up. That's Peter back to Steve, and he'll have to take the settler. Sirenen, someone worrying about his work rate, and he's hurt, and he's lost the ball. So David Manson will have to pack a scrum with New South Wales' feet, I would say.
Yeah, some clever work there from Steve Walters. Has really well hit there, Bob Linden, by three New South Wales forwards. Loses the ball. Stephen Walters sees that and immediately then puts it beside Linden so that the Maroons maintain it.
Well, actually, he's ruled that the player was injured, so Queensland end up retaining possession.
Great kick from Shearer.
Now Wishart had a touch of the fumbles in Lang Park at his last encounter, but he runs it straight tonight. And he's tackled midway between the 22 and quarter.
Gavin Allan getting up with Bob Linder still on the ground.
So Elias.
Steve Jackson, in fact, on the deck.
Cartwright. He's short of the halfway. Now Elias. Simon to Sirenen standing wide, trying to put Fittler into a hole. Now, have they got numbers? Queensland's cover's coming. Here's Daly. He's signalling the inside for McGregor. Now runs inside and out, and Clyde's beside him. McGregor still going. He takes it within 10 metres of the line. Clyde was looming on his outside. Elias the dummy half through Simon Eddinghausen. What's he do? He finds a hole. He's hit a bit high by Shearer. He takes the tackle. They're on number six. What do they do? Do they go to the air or do they grub it? They throw it. And Mackay. Well, has that gone forward? It's play on. And Harrigan goes to ground. And that will be the first changeover of the match. But McGregor, the debutant, giving the Queensland backs plenty to think about. So Queensland now on their own 22-metre line. Martin Bella out of the danger zone. Gavin Allan on in 16. Steve Walters to Larson. That's his second touch.
But another penalty to Queensland here as Manson calls out Paul Sirenen. Now, whether it was just for the facial massage he gave Queenslander on that occasion, it's Gary Larson taking it up. He's perhaps hit him high. He's come around, yes, chin high, I'd suggest. Then comes in with the elbow, then the facial massage. Take the trifecta.
Steve Jackson, very groggy. Leaves the field, the assistant of the Queensland doctor, Keith Woodhead. Now, Martin Bella over the advantage line and the halfway. This is a very, very tough opening 10 minutes of rugby league. Gavin Allan, he takes it five short, or five over the halfway. Steve Walters, now Langer. So what do the backs do? Walters can't find a hole. He's wrapped up by Clyde. Typical cover defence tackle, also Daly. Meninga goes to dummy half. Jackson's on his left. Well, Larson had overrun the pass, so Jackson had to take the tackle. And Walters has made a meal of it at dummy half. Queensland, I don't think Andrew Slack have settled down.
Now, Steve Walters was then deciding whether or not there was a space for him to dart from dummy half. Looked up the same time the ball came back, and hence the knock on. Bear in mind that it's a six replacement rule being played in this match.
So Eddinghausen, Fittler. Inside to Mackay. The big fellow's off. Here's Shearer, he's got too much pace for him. And he'll bowl him into touch. And that's not good play from Mackay. He's undone all the good work. Shearer showed him the touchline, the experience of Dale Shearer, and he had too much toe.
Yes, I don't know that he had many options, though, with Shearer coming from behind him. Good teamwork there, the Penrith pair. Fittler and Mackay there setting up that 50-metre break. Good work as well from Shearer.
So Willie Kahn in off the wing, runs at Eddinghausen, and he puts him down. Just outside the 22. Larson. Underneath was Clyde. Everything he does, Bradley Clyde, out of the textbook. Walters to Langer. Now to Kevin Walters, and Meninga now takes on Daly and Sirenham, and he loses. He lost about 3 metres. So Kevin Walters now at dummy half. The Shearer. Well, that's not a real good kick. Now Wishart, he's only got about 2 to beat, but he comes inside to play safety. Larson chases him, and Hancock finishes him off.
And it wasn't really the time to play safety. It was one-on-one as the late... A late call then comes in, and first penalty of the match to New South Wales.
Well, Greg Dowling, what do you think so far?
Well, New South Wales forwards have been stung by the criticism they can't defend, and they're out here to prove a point. Steve Jackson, when he left the field, he was in a lot of trouble, and I don't expect to see him for a while, but all they've got to do is just settle down, and the rest of the game will take its course.
OK, here's New South Wales with a chance to put on the pressure as they take the tap just inside the quarter line. Elias, he'll get it away then to Lazarus. Lazarus straight ahead. Gavin Allan coming in over the top to put him down. Away from dummy half, back over it goes to Simon outside to Sirenan, and those forwards charging up. Sirenan takes 3 men to put him over. Dummy half will be Elias. The pressure's really on now from New South Wales. They've really started far better than Queensland, I feel, at the moment. Elias doubles around. Now he gets a pass away to Clyde. Clyde going for the corner. He's going to score. The first try of the match for New South Wales. Bradley Clyde is over after only 8 minutes of play.
And very much the way the first few minutes of this game have been going. New South Wales totally dominant, and Paul Sirenan, whose club form this year has been pretty ordinary, he got New South Wales into that position, and then the runaround, one of the great plays in rugby league. It's simple enough to do, but when you've got players of the class of Bradley Clyde involved, it often brings 4 points.
4 points at dead, he goes over in the corner.
And see, the key being, Elias threw that pass and came around to again take it, set up Daly, Clyde too fast outside his clubmate Mal Meninga.
So New South Wales draw first blood here at the Sydney Football Stadium. Bradley Clyde, what a footballer this fellow is. And they've got off to a flying start here.
Yes, the best news for New South Wales is the fact that a couple of their debutants, Paul McGregor especially, and the wing on the wing, Graham Mackay, have both had something to do and done it quite well. That will give them confidence.
Yeah, certainly give them plenty, all right. There's Mal Meninga, the Queensland captain, down with his team in the in-goal area. Well, they've lost Steve Jackson, Gavin Allan out there. I would suggest that the coach for the Queensland side, Graham Lowe, wouldn't have wanted to be using Gavin Allan as early as this.
No, indeed he wouldn't. But he'd be more worried about the fact that Steve Jackson looks as if he could be doubtful to come back, and he's then down to 16 men. Well, Rod Wishart kicking for goal. Bear in mind that he is not kicking for Illawarra this year. Ryan Girdler's got that job, so he hasn't had many to do. At the same time, he kicked a clanger for country against City from the sideline, so he's obviously doing a bit of practice.
He knows what it's all about. He kicked for New South Wales in the 1990 series. He's back onto his mark now. Rod Wishart looking for the extra 2 points. It's looking all right. It's coming around well. It's got to be there. That's a great goal. That's a terrific kick, and it's 6 points to nil.
For the savings you make, with Metway Bank's range of very competitive home loans, individually designed to be financially comfortable. For the support you receive from your Metway manager, who'll get you into your new home quickly and easily. For whatever reason, there is no other bank like Metway Bank. You've never had a better reason to change.
So from the kickoff, New South Wales bring it up via Paul Sirenan, and he will end up about 11 metres out from the New South Wales line. Well, Wishart might have only had 4 kicks so far this year, but he didn't let that worry him. He belted that one down as if he'd been doing it for about all of the year. So now it's Lazarus getting up to play it. Elias away from dummy half. And he'll turn it back inside to Harrigan. So from the play of the ball, back over to Cartwright. Cartwright's going to be wrapped up. Larson in underneath. Coming in over the top is Gavin Allan. Also in there was Gilmeister. They'll swing it back to John Simon. Simon kicks downfield. bounces up reasonably okay for Shearer, but it went over his, out of his hands, behind him. He steps his way through. Eventually going to be wrapped up about 25 metres out from the Queensland line. So away from dummy half. Queensland trying to find a way up via Michael Hancock. That's Gary Larson with it now, but he's well wrapped up. Harrigan and also Elias combining. Steve Walters from dummy half. It came out awkwardly, so the player coming through and overrun the ball. That's Jackson. Tackled by Laurie Daly, together with Cartwright. So New South Wales have an early lead of 6 points to nil. That's Martin Bella. He unloads it. Going outside this time is Trevor Gilmeister. Final tackle is on its way. Back to Allan Langer. Is he going to kick this time? He got away from Elias. Kicks across field. Ettinghausen is back there. Takes it just inside the quarter. Plenty of parade up there on this occasion. And eventually they're going to pull him down. Gary Larson, the one to follow in after the tackle of Kevin Walters. So it's Laurie Daly from dummy half. Wishart looking for a little bit of work.
Taking a leaf out of the Queensland wingers books. Wishart looking for work. Certainly that's what Michael Hancock and Willie Kahn do. How do you think Queensland will bounce back from that early try, Greg?
Well, it was a good opening passage there by New South Wales. They've had all the play in Queensland's half. What they've got to do is just kick the ball back to him, even if it means kicking on the early tackles, just to hem New South Wales back in their half, and then hopefully they will come up with a mistake.
Sheridan taken a little bit high on that occasion by Gilmeister. Elias from dummy half back to Simon. He can turn on to Daly. Daly tackled well by his clubmate Meninga. He got it back to no one. Ball still rolling on the ground, but it's going to be the turnover. So Queensland now, let's see what they can do with it. This is Gavin Allan, straight ahead, taken by Elias, but it was a good strong run from him on this occasion. The other tackler was Laurie Daly. Langer away to Larson. Larson upended. Coming in underneath in the tackle was Cartwright. They're almost up on the quarter line. Meninga comes up as dummy half. He'll send it away to Martin Bella. Bella hemmed up on the quarter line, but a penalty to come into Queensland. New South Wales too eager on this occasion.
I'm not 100% sure that Mal Meninga will be delighted with that. On attack the first time in the 22. Given the penalty, he'll obviously try and kick for goal. He'll come through offside, getting them back the 5 metres. He'll have to kick for goal, but it's not an easy one. So if he misses the kick, he'll be looking to get it over that dead ball line. Gary Larson getting through a lot of work in both attack and defence for Queensland at this stage.
Well, Mal Meninga is placing the ball about 25 metres back from the line and about 8 in from touch. He's the greatest point scorer of all time in State of Origin football.
This man on screen, Benny Elias, has been making a bit of headway from the dummy half. Queensland knows he's going well. They'd be keen to bottle him up.
A couple of them going well there. Shearer and making some good ground and taking several players to pull him down. So well, they've got three in there looking after him. There's a few gaps appearing in other places, aren't there? So here's Meninga. Looking for the first Queensland points. The deep breath. Talks to himself. Come on, Mal, you need it, he says. Len Lazarus. You're not going to get it. He's on his way. He's not going to get it either. It's away to the left-hand side of the uprights. In New South Wales, a pin back in the quarter, in
Peter
the in-goal area.
Outstanding tackle.
Big tackle, all right, coming in over there on McGregor. Drove him back into the in-goal area, and so it'll be a drop out from underneath the goal bar. Well, that's something positive from the Queensland point of view.
Yes, and certainly good mentally as well. Had that ball been taken out from behind the try line, they would have lost all that momentum they got getting into the 22, but that tackle of Jackson will have lifted the spirits. They now need to get that ball back there. Queensland had a hit back straight away.
Allan Langer scoops it back behind. Eventually, Willie Kahn comes away with it, running right across field. Got away from Bradley Clyde, got away from McGregor. He's on his way. He's looking for his support. He turns it back inside. Shearer steps out of one tackle. Got to be wrapped up. Got it back. They keep it going, Queensland. But eventually going to be put down only a couple of metres out from that New South Wales line. From the play of the ball. Jackson sending it back to Langer. Langer holding back the pass, going to do all sorts of things. Runs across field. Fittler gets a hold of him. He gets away to Gavin Allan. Back inside to Shearer. Shearer runs around. This is Meninga. Meninga, he gets his pass outside. In the corner. No. In a touch. In a touch it was. Bobby Lindner going for the corner. But in a touch. Not much in it.
No, but I think the correct decision from the touch judge, as we see, there's a foot there. Just touches. The tag's touch before the ball goes down. Good decision from the touch judge.
Still not much in it, though.
Out's out.
That is out, all right. So the scrum to pack down 10 metres out from the New South Wales line. Simon gets it away this time to his winger coming across in Graham Mackay. GD, a little bit more positive now from this Maroon team.
No, they found their way into the game now, and they've got New South Wales where they want them, down in their half. What they've got to do now is what they haven't been doing before, is move up in a straight line and chop them off.
So this is Harrigan taking it up. He'll be tackled by Larson underneath. Over the top was Meninga. So out to Brad Fittler. Fittler back inside, Laurie Daly. Daly gets it away, taken by Clyde again. He took it one-handed, took it beautifully, actually. He's put down about 2 metres short of the halfway mark. New South Wales with a lead of 6 points to nil. Back to Andrew Eddinghausen. He'll drive it downfield. Back there is Dale Shearer. Shearer's been well composed tonight. He'll run it out. And eventually going to be tackled about 30 metres out from his own line.
Good variety from New South Wales. John Simon, not the only man doing the kicking. He's dishing it occasionally to Laurie Daly, also to Andrew Eddinghausen, as in that case. And that'll just put that bit of uncertainty in the defenders' minds from the Queensland point of view.
So Gavin Allan takes it over the advantage line and gets the pass back to Stephen Walters. And Queensland already at the halfway mark. They trail on the scoreboard by 6 points to nil. Martin Bella's over the halfway. He's over it by about 8 metres.
Laurie Daly popping off. He's got what seems to be a twisted ankle, attended by the New South Wales trainers. Langer shoots away.
Well, he shot away momentarily till he ran into Freddie Fittler and he put him down. Now it goes back to Shearer.
It's Mackay on Bradley Clyde, the injured player. Brad Mackay on for him.
Eddinghausen. And now for Queensland, it's about containment. Wishart to dummy half.
There you see Bradley Clyde on the ground and in some agony.
So it's now Elias to dummy half. Queensland a bit slow getting off, and Elias went the dummy. Couldn't fool Lindner. Steve Walters also tagged him. Here's Mackay. That's Bradley Mackay. Lazarus takes it to the centre of the ground, five short of the halfway. They're on the final tackle, the Blues. Here's Simon. Hancock. Great chasing from New South Wales. Mackay can't just hold Hancock. Yes, he can. Daly went in to finish him off, and Surinam also lended support. Now Shearer. He's good in broken play. He takes it within a metre of the 22. To Stephen Walters. Now Langer. He doesn't want Lindner. He wants Meninga. Khan. The New South Wales defence want him. Bella. Takes it outside the quarter. Now it goes through Langer. Comes back the other way. Elias gets in. So Lindner decides to put the boot to him. Well, the chase is not good here from Queensland. Eddinghausen's got stack of time to run it back. He runs it 8 metres outside the quarter. Here's Wishart. Can't break the tackle. As we go to Sean Lawson and just check on the Queensland injuries and the New South Wales injuries as well, Sean.
Yeah, it looks like Steve Jackson has concussion. Very iffy whether he'll be back on the field. And Bradley Clyde has an ankle injury.
All right. Now we're back with Harrigan. Oh, Queensland didn't go up and meet him. And the big fellow ran it to the halfway. Here's Elias. The forwards are going forward for the Blues and the backs are getting leeway. They're 10 metres inside Queensland territory. Now it's gone to Simon. That's a ripper.
Yes, and I think that's as a result of the fact that they have changed the kicker from time to time, and the Queensland defence very slow to go up on Simon, perhaps looking to see what the alternatives were. He had plenty of time, saw the gap there through the Queensland ruck and punched the left foot right by the try line, about 3 or 4 metres out. They're in a great position, Greg Dowling.
Yeah, he's certainly growing in stature as the game goes on. They've got to get up and pressure him.
So Queensland with Shearer, 10 out from their own line. Tackler is Daly. Kevin Walters up as the dummy half. Now for Peter Jackson, but Bradley Mackay was up quickly. The Blues up very quickly in the defensive line. So Lindner goes to dummy half. And he's made a half break. Who's with him? Meninga. Pass back to Walters, I think it is.
Steve Walters.
And he's tackled short of the halfway. So his brother Kevin goes to dummy half. Now it goes to Langer. Jackson's looking for a hole. Can't find it. He's popped one up. Hancock tidies up. Can't beat Surinam's tackle. And now they're on the final one to Langer for territory. Graham McCoy. One-on-one with Khan. And he runs it about 18 out from his own line. So John Simon over to Daly. Takes it up like a front rower. Draws applause from the New South Wales Sydney Football Stadium crowd. Lazarus trying to stand in the tackle. 32 out from their own line. They lead by 6 points to nil. Cartwright can't beat the tackle of Bella and Linda. Harrigan. This time Queensland move up better in defence and the big fellow doesn't gain momentum. This will be for Simon. Oh, he wrong foots a couple. And the chasing from New South Wales, very good. Well, there comes Simon. That's good work from John Simon. Shearer was trying to milk a penalty from the offside, but Simon ran through.
He has been very impressive so far, not only in his kicking game, but the great tackle on Mal Meninga before that stopped a Queensland thrust. So he's really living up to the night and doing what all those fans of his expected.
Larson. 32 out from their own line, Queensland. Gilmister. Can't beat Cartwright and Daly. So Stephen Walters. Langer. Now Kevin Walters. What can he do? Watch out what he can do. He can find a hole. Now it's gone to Allan Langer. Eddinghausen's got him covered. It's gone back to Jackson. There's blue jerseys everywhere and he takes the tackle. And they're only about 13 or 14 out from the line. Khan goes the dummy half. Langer trying to switch it out the back and he might throw it into touch. Khan will have to tidy up. Stays in the field of play. Shearer puts it up. How's the bounce? Well, there's no one chasing. But now they eventually catch up. And so Queensland will get possession back. Martin Bella, one of the chasers with Stephen Walters. And Benny Elias was the man that went to ground.
Yeah, there's no doubt the Queensland chasing hasn't been up to normal standard. They put not a lot of pressure on the New South Wales team. That took up the individual and it was a lucky bounce as far as Queensland was concerned there. And Stephen Walters on his Pat Malone for a while until Martin Bella came. So a stroke of fortune for the Queenslanders.
17 minutes to go before half-time. New South Wales lead 6 points to nil. A try to Bradley Clyde in the eighth minute. Converted by Rod Wishart. It's trapped. So Langer to Meninga. He needs to hit it full ball. He takes it back towards the quarter. Gavin Allan. Hands free. Back to Stephen Walters. Now to Kevin. Who wants to go into the gap? He can't put anyone away there. 10 out from the line. Queensland will play it through Stephen Walters. Langer calling the tune. Who wants it? Meninga's inside and he's tackled about 3 metres out from the line. Bobby Linder goes to dummy half. He won't try his strength. It goes to Langer. Where are the runners? Stephen Walters. Linder. Hangs on and takes it within 2 metres of the try line. He'll play it to Meninga. Will he try his own fortune with his bulk? No, he shifts it. And they have numbers out wide. Allan decides to take the tackle back to Langer. That'll be 4 points. They've got it back. Gavin Allan, I thought momentarily he'd done the wrong thing. The numbers were left. He stood on the tackle. Allan Langer backing up beside the post. And after the kick, this should make it 6 points apiece.
Great play from Queensland and Gavin Allan in particular. We see in screen he came on in the early minutes for Steve Jackson, who was concussed. Gavin Allan, a noted defender, he showed his ball skills there. He took the New South Wales defence left, popped it inside on his right to Allan Langer. Allan Langer saw that gap, bang, it was outside Paul Surinam and he scooted between Brad Mackay and Paul Harrigan. The try Queensland needed, Greg Dowling.
Gavin Allan popping that pass up and Langer, Johnny on the spot. And Queensland are starting to just gradually ease their way back into this match.
Yes, and I just noticed in the last few minutes, New South Wales looking very tight. It was a full-on assault for those first 15 or 20 minutes. And they were going in twos and threes and really committed to the tackle. They've just fallen off one or two tackles here, going in ones or twos, and really haven't looked quite as impressive in defence.
That looked like dying down here on the right-hand side, and New South Wales just sort of hung back a bit from them. Then that big long pass across field set it up. They weren't looking too impressive.
That's right, where Bob Lindner held it on for that second. They just seemed not to know where to go as we see Mal Meninga line up. The second attempt, one from one.
That's a level ball game. It's 6-6. We'll take a break and be back.
For the reward of a smart rate term deposit with an interest rate that can rise but never fall below a preset minimum. For the reputation of Metway Bank's friendly staff who'll help you make some smart decisions of your own. For whatever reason, there is no other bank like Metway Bank. You've never had a better reason to change.
From the kickoff, Khan's dropped it. From the kickoff, he's dropped it. Now, McGregor, the big fellow inside the quarter. Well, there's a mistake from the kickoff. Queensland had just got back into the match, and now they have to hold on. This is Harrigan underneath Jackson. He puts him to the ground, 10 out from the try line. Elias is calling for Lazarus to hit it up, and the big fellow runs it within 5 metres of the try line. Now Elias to call the tune. Who's the runners? Sirinen. Held up, goes to ground, four out. Queensland have to hold on. Simon waits for it. Long pass. Oh, it's not a good one. Ettinghausen won't pick it up. Fittler will. And, well, New South Wales blew that. They had a big opportunity. Now they're on the final tackle with Brad McKay. Over to Daly. Stabs it. Shearer. There's only two chases. Ettinghausen's one. McKay. Graham McKay is the other. And Dale Shearer's tackled five out from his own line. I bet you Khan won't drop this one. He's 10 out from his try line. Stephen Walters to Gavin Allan. Almost at the quarter. Martin Bell is looking for it. Steve Walters then switches play to Gilmister. And he's outside the 22. The pace starting to slow just noticeably. Langer doing well. Now they're on the final tackle. The New South Wales wingers dropping back slowly. It's a slow play of the ball. Shearer straight down Ettinghausen's throat. But the chase is all right. The chase is pretty good from A. Langer. Now Elias. Over to Graham McKay. Tackled by Gary Larson. Wishart and Elias didn't know who was supposed to go to dummy half, and that was the result, nothing. Now, Elias looking for Lazarus. And he's met by the Queensland defence. And all of a sudden, one gets the impression the Queensland defence might be just starting to win out. Sirinen stood that, took it off a flat. What do you think, Greg Dowling?
Yeah, they're starting to tire a bit. They're not moving up in the straight line, and they're letting New South Wales get a few balls away. I just see David Gillespie waiting to come on. He'll add a bit of starch to their defence.
Can Shearer add a little bit of starch from his near his own try line? It goes to ground. So Stephen Walters goes to dummy half, over to Larson. He'll play safety first. And has dropped the ball. Lazarus wanted to play on. Larson's down injured.
Yes, and Harrigan over the top, I think, is probably the reason that Gary Larson isn't feeling $1 million. That's Terry Coyne in front of Coyne in front of Graham Lowe. Coyne coming on as a replacement for Gary Larson would naturally cause a reshuffle. But is this coming over the top here from Paul Harrigan? I think that's done the damage.
It's done the damage, all right.
Paul Sirinen coming off for New South Wales.
And a good move from Phil Gould. I think Gillespie's the man that needs to do it now. Sirinen had a fantastic first half hour. He really took it on, but in that last 5 or 10 minutes fell away a little.
Now, Dave Ryan's call for the stretcher for Larson as Lowe gives Coyne his instructions. And play has been stopped.
Well, just have a look now. He's in a lot of trouble. They've got the stretcher out there. Larson did cop one, didn't he, up high there. There's Coyne warming up. Now, what's going to happen here, Andrew?
Well, I wonder, would this see Mal Meninga go into the forwards?
No, that's got to be the thing, but he wouldn't like to be messing around too much out there, but he hasn't got any choice, has he?
Mal into the second row. Bob Lynn and Halock, perhaps, and Coyne in the slot into the centres.
Wouldn't be the worst thing they could do.
And they've got Gary Coyne sitting back there also. But meanwhile, Steve Jackson, a bit of trouble out there for Gary Larson.
Well, one wonders if Graham Lowe is thinking that way, that it would be good to get Meninga into it by putting him in the second row, because the obvious replacement would be Gary Coyne slot into the second row, Bobby Lindner back to lock. But he's not chosen that option. So when play resumes, and it's taking a little time because Gary Larson is obviously not all that well, Greg Dowling, the choice of Mark Coyne, one that surprises you?
Yes, it certainly does, but I agree with you. You might see Mal going into the pack and add a bit more oomph where they need it and try to get over that advantage line. But I tell you what, we haven't seen the end of that tackle either.
Well, this is not, Greg Dowling, this is not Queensland's happy hunting ground for injuries. I remember back, I think, in 89 with Bobby Lindner playing with a broken ankle. Well, Allan Langer broke his leg. Blakes were going. I think Queensland finished that match with 12 men.
Yeah, they did. They copped a few injuries down here, and tonight's no different. But that's what state of origin football is all about. You know, it's fast and furious, and the body sometimes gives way.
So you think we might be hearing more about that hit, do you?
Yes, I do. It was a bit high, and, that'll be up to the New South Wales Rugby League to take a look at it.
They're ready to pack that scrum, but the players still take the stretcher bearer is still taking Gary Larson off. And apart from every other consideration, they'll miss his work rate. He really has been putting in the tackles as well as taking the ball up strongly.
Well, guess who is the lock forward? Would you pick Peter Jackson? That's what's happened. Here it comes to McGregor. McGregor's going to be tackled by Mal Meninga. He's put down about 30 metres out from the Queensland line. Dummy half is Fittler. Fittler will get it away to Mackay. Mackay's got to be tackled up there by Coyne. Elias is the dummy half. This is Davids, or rather Gillespie. Gillespie looking to take it up, and they'll expect a bit of work from him in the final 9.5 minutes of this first half. That's Cartwright just inside the quarter. Elias dummy half. Simon getting it away to Daly. Daly away to McGregor. McGregor well tackled this time by Peter Jackson. It is the final tackle now. So back, it's going to be lost. Lost over there by Harrigan, picked up by Simon, but the referee to play the knock. So the scrum will go down about 20 metres out. No, it'll be the changeover. 20 metres out from the Queensland line. So 9 minutes remaining in this first half. It's 6-6 at the moment. And a big start from New South Wales, but Queensland grinding their way back into it. But a long, long way to go. Steve Walters from dummy half. Outside to Martin Bella. Bella tackled by Lazarus. He just slipped out of Lazarus's tackle. Eventually going to be finished off in the tackle coming about from Cartwright. Steve Walters trying to slip away from dummy half. He was also looking for a runner outside, but just couldn't position himself to get the pass away. Jackson can. He finds Bobby Lindner coming through. He'll be put down about 3 or 4 metres short of the halfway line. So Walters to Langer. Langer up over halfway, dodging, weaving, got away from Harrigan. Got his pass, it's flicked across field, they're still going, this is Coyne. Coyne shapes the kick, has got him wrapped up by Daly, but he's made it to 10 metres inside New South Wales territory.
Great hands again from Gavin Allan, kept that move going.
So here we go on the final tackle, a kick going to go across over there by Walters, but it went straight to Wishart. Wishart starting to run around again, and eventually will be put down by the man who kicked the ball through, and Kevin Walters. So from the play the ball, New South Wales in possession, but they get a penalty, Queensland offside. So a penalty for New South Wales with Laurie Daly running up. But he'll give it away to Elias, who in turn gives it to Andrew Ettinghausen, and he will kick for touch. There
plenty,
it is.
Plenty of Queenslanders in screen, but not David Manson. He can't be in front of the referee. It's supposed to be 5 metres, but if he's back 10, you've got to get back with him.
That's Graham Lowe, looking a little anxious at this stage. 7.5 minutes remaining in this first half. So New South Wales to put on the pressure again. Can they do it? This is Lazarus. Lazarus still working away, a couple of metres from that line now, from the play of the ball, back over to Simon, Simon to Gillespie, Gillespie no chance of getting away, little Allan Langer came in around the ball, Elias, on this time to Cartwright, they're looking for a runner inside, Fittler went through, but he's standing up for the tackle, he got away from the tackle of Coyne, he's still going, Bella grabs a hold of him this time, He'll play the ball. Dummy half Elias. Elias swings it across over there to Simon. Simon outside to Daly. Daly looking for a runner too, but Allan Langer is there. Langer grabs a hold of him.
Gee, they had numbers out right there.
So Ricky Stewart watching it there. Would have been out there in the match tonight, but John Simon is taking his place because of injury. And he's gone pretty well too. Here's the final tackle coming up. Elias, they work the blind side. Over it goes to Wishart in the corner, and he's lost the ball and tackled into touch. Into touch, about 5 metres short of that line.
That really is outstanding defence from Queensland. Every one of them, Allan Langer in there, Martin Bella doing a lot of work. Really fine defence. And New South Wales just a bit lost for alternatives at the moment.
Well, they've had a couple of opportunities where they've had penalties and ended up with the ball in the various good positions where they could do something with it, but failed to go on. Greg Dowling, we're at this stage about just over 6 minutes remaining in this first half. How do you see it?
Well, this is the danger period, 10 minutes before halftime. Queensland have just got to work it out and get out of their territory. I just see young Larson is heavily concussed and he's bleeding from the ear, so I don't think we'll see him tonight.
So he probably wouldn't have hit that ear when he landed on the ground, would he?
Well, like I said before, I think a lot will be seen out of this tackle.
So it's Queensland in possession now. They're midway between the quarter and halfway, down in their own territory. It is the final tackle. So Allan Langer is the kicker this time. Back over the head of Andrew Ettinghausen, but Ettinghausen able to get back there. Oh, he's lost it through his legs. Play on, says a referee. He runs across field, got away from the first tackle coming in. He's still going as ET, but eventually runs into Michael Hancock on the far side of the field, and Hancock drives him back a couple of metres, but a good run from the New South Wales fullback after he looked pretty shaky in the early part of it there.
Yeah, but not a great chasing again from Queensland, only three or four up, and a man of Ettinghausen's pace can get the ball, he can go across field and look for opportunities when there's only that many players. That's just what he did, and there's a hole to be found.
Elias turned it back inside to Wishart, but he's got to be wrapped up. The tackler over there was Coyne, or rather Gavin Allan. From the play the ball now, New South Wales bring it to about a metre inside Queensland territory. It's still 6-6 at the Sydney Football Stadium. But now a look for Mackay. Mackay takes it up. Bottled up on the final tackle. Elias to dummy half. He'll swing it back to Simon and they keep it going. Daly's going to be the kicker this time. He decides to kick. Well, I don't know what he was trying to do with that one. He looked one way, then went the other way and eventually kicked it into touch.
That's it. He gave himself too many options. Took the one in the middle, which didn't work.
I think he confused himself, all right. So now Queensland to play the ball a couple of metres short of the halfway. They get it up over there via the efforts on that occasion of Stephen Bond. That's Martin Bella. The tackler is Gillespie. On it goes this time to Gilmeister. We've got under a swinging arm of Cartwright coming through. They're 10 metres inside New South Wales territory. Walters back to Gilmeister. Dummy half is Steve Walters to Allan Langer. Langer decides to shift it out. This is Jackson. Got it away nicely to Coyne. Coyne up over the quarter line. Turns it back inside to Meninga. Meninga looking for support. He can't find anyone. He goes to ground about 18 metres out. And here's the final tackle. So the dummy half is Coyne. Nice piece of work from the replacement player there. They swing it on the blind side. This is Langer. Little chip over the top. Going back there is Simon, but he dives on it in the in-goal area.
Again, the support and the chasing of the Queenslanders, not, I think, what Graham Lowe would want. Mark Coyne made that break. He gave it inside to Meninga, as we see Langer chip through. Nobody coming from the left there to put pressure on Simon. Langer just chasing himself. But I just think a bit disappointing there, chasing and pressure, Greg.
Yeah, so I think you hit it right on the head there before. They're not putting together passes enough. You know, the forwards are going to run two out and three out instead of one out. New South Wales are just picking them off. All they've got to do is just put a couple of short passes together, break them up.
Although that the 17 trainers a squad, the disruption caused by those two early losses of the forge, do you think that would upset perhaps the teamwork just for time?
Yes, until they get momentum going, but they all should know the plays. You know, they've trained together for a week and Queensland have been together for a long time, so they should know each other's play and it should just roll on.
Allan Langer with it now. That is the quarter line. You can see he turns it back inside. It's going to be lost by Michael Hancock. Picked up by Laurie Daly. 2.75 minutes to go in this first half of the match. New South Wales about 30 metres out from their own line. Wishart slipped out of the first half tackle of Langer, decided to go again. Dummy half is Fittler now. Fittler turning it back inside. Gillespie. He's going to be tackled by Gilmeister together with Steve Walters. Elias to dummy half. Oh, they don't know who they're going to give it to. Eventually McGregor comes away with it. He knows what to do though. He's up over the halfway mark. He's looking for support. Broke away from the tackle of Khan. Puts a little kick in. Now whether he was tripped or not, I don't know. We'll soon see. The referee says no.
Great cover, Allan Lang, and good decision, Manson.
So from the play, the ball coin away from dummy half is going to be grabbed by Elias. Just under 2 minutes remaining in the first half. So when it goes to Meninga. Meninga turns it back inside to Michael Hancock. Decides to have a run, but is going to be tackled by Cartwright. Just over the quarter line. Crowd not too happy with the decision of Manson. This is Martin Bella. Bella takes it up. Tackler going to be McGregor again, together with Elias. This is Gilmeister. Gilmeister put over 10 metres short of halfway. The final tackle, a minute and a half remaining in the first half. We're still locked together at 6-all. Jackson's kick downfield. This one is not going to get away from Ettinghausen. Takes it on the first bounce. Now he brings it up. Not many chases here again at all this time. Oh, the ball flies to no one. Queensland will come through and get it. Kevin Walters takes it on the toe. Daly's going to be back there to take it. A metre out from his own line. He's going to be tackled and picked down up there.
Yeah, reasonable option there from Kevin Walters. He could have dived on the ball and hoped for things, but with just 60 seconds to go, is Laurie Daly's left knee.
Yes.
He's struggled with it, and he's struggling again. Graeme Mackay showing a fair bit of concern for his skipper. He's going to play the ball. Manson will allow the strapper to come on. We'll keep you informed of Laurie Daly's injuries. On his feet now.
Mackay plays it back to Fittler. Fittler's going to be driven back in the tackle of Lindner. He'll play it to Cartwright.
Unsteady as he picked that up, of course, and then the pressure by Kevin Walters.
Yes, and it turned right back at the end, too. We'll keep an eye on Laurie Daly.
And Martin Bella wanted a debate on his platform earlier in the week, but there's no room for debate tonight. He's played extremely well in this first half.
Well, he always seems to do it in State of Origin. He just comes out and proves them wrong every time. He was a very determined man during the week, I can tell you that. This is the final tackle. As Elias drops back there as dummy half. The kick downfield by Simon. Back over the head of Dale Shearer. And you'll just about hear the halftime hooter go right now. There it is. Shearer takes it up. He sends it back inside to Hancock. Hancock trying to get away from Simon. He throws it back inside and we pull down by Shearer. They lose it. Elias comes away with it. Wrapped up over there, and it's halftime. And halftime at the Sydney Football Stadium sees Queensland and New South Wales locked together at 6 points all.
And a fair indication of the play. I thought New South Wales well and truly superior in the first 20 minutes, vice versa the second 20. Queensland came back into it. So obviously 6-all, I don't have to say it's an even contest, but very spirited early. I think both sides have tied towards that latter part of the half because they gave so much. And there's Martin Bell, he's one man who should be tied.
All right, well, there's a couple of injury worries which we'll find out a little bit more about at half time. But at the half-time break, New South Wales and Queensland 6-all here at the Sydney Football Stadium.
Yourself and three mates the ultimate Forex big league action experience. Collect the tokens from your favorite Forex cartons and be in the draw to take your mates to two State of Origin matches, two tests against the Poms, and this year's Sydney Grand Final. Plus 500 Origin tickets, footy gear, and the chance to join the Channel 9 commentary team at the Lang Park Origin match.
Forex, yeah, we're winners out here.
Collect your tokens now.
Look what's in store for Mum this Mother's Day at Mitre 10. Great gift ideas from Black & Decker, like the Auto Celsius 1.8-litre kettle with super fast boil, just $49.95. Ironing seems easy with Black & Decker's Light and Easy Advanced System Iron with variable steam control and soft clean system, only $59.95. And the Toast Plus has long, extra wide slots for toasting muffins or crumpets. Another great gift at $49.95. It's all in our Mother's Day catalogue, out now at your local Mitre 10.
I like it when Mum lets my friends stay over.
Reward your mum at KFC from now till Mother's Day.
I like it when Mum's not home.
With the Mum's Reward Pack, 16 pieces of chicken plus a free Sara Lee Black Forest cake to show Mum you think she's great.
A free Sara Lee Black Forest cake for Mum?
And I like it like that.
Okay, I do like it when she's home.
Mum's Reward, 16 pieces and a free Sara Lee Black Forest cake.
Everything else is just hot air.
Whoa. You okay?
Sure. Just thought I'd drop in. Would you like a drink?
Oh, I bet.
I know. Let's have some fun. Let's nibble Nobby's nuts.
Candler's sale is on, with all appliances and microwaves reduced for Mother's Day. With loads of bonus gifts and bonus prizes. Candler's Mother's Day sale, on now.
Check it out at Candler's Electric Appliance Stores.
Nine told me all about the big events.
Nine told me so.
They made it clear and gave it sense.
So I know everything I need to know, 'cause Nine told me so.
And welcome back to the Sydney Football Stadium with me, Greg Dowling. The way you saw the first 40 minutes.
Well, I thought Queensland were lucky to go into half-time at 6 points all. New South Wales had a better play and we're on the back foot all the time. I think they lost a lot of momentum, New South Wales, when Bradley Clyde went off, and I don't expect to see him again.
All right, let's have a look at the first half highlights, keeping in mind it's 6 points all at half-time. Let's have a look at the action in the first half. And New South Wales started off with a rush. They threw everything at Queensland, and in the end, the first try, after they put on plenty of pressure here through Fittler, and they reverse play a lot in the first 10 or 15 minutes, didn't they?
Yeah, they did. That's what caught Queensland out, as you can see. They fell off a lot of tackles. They seem to be running around nowhere.
He's going all right, McGregor.
Yes, he's a fine player, and he's proven that tonight.
So that gave the New South Wales spectators plenty to stand up and cheer about. Eddie Howson into the back line to take it within 10 metres of the line. And here, the great ball skills, Simon. And you'll see Elias come around in about a couple of play the balls to send Clyde over. And I noticed when they went off, GD, when Clyde went off, everything changed.
Yeah, they did. They use him running out wide a lot. He breaks the first tackle a lot of times for them. They miss that now, and the rest of them are just pretty well grafters. Here's where the try has come up now.
Elias to make the extra man, and Clyde getting outside Meninga and having too much pace. And he looked pretty tickled pink with the way he got the ball down over the try line, and so did the spectators at the Sydney Football Stadium. Wishart, a gem.
A superb kick. This guy doesn't kick for his club side. Incredible.
You couldn't kick him like that, could you?
Mate, I put one over from the sideline many, many years ago.
Yeah, we can't tell our grandkids about it. But Queensland, to their defence, they really came back. Langer, they found very hard to put on the deck. And Gavin Allan, who just handled then, who creates the first try for Allan Langer, had to come on very early in the piece. Bobby Lindner putting his foot into touch just before getting the ball down. This was tight.
Yes, it certainly was. Bob did well to get in there, but unfortunately, as you can see, the foot slipped out. But I just think Queensland are relying too much on Elf. Here it is, Gavin Allan straightening the tack up. Back to Elf, and he dives over under the post.
Meninga making the conversion, and it's 6 points all. I thought towards the latter part of the first half that Queensland were gaining a little bit of momentum, but Larson leaving the field sort of shook things up a bit.
Yes, it did. Well, Larson is a workaholic. You know, I think he probably would have had 20-odd tackles up at halftime. It was a great kick by Mal there to bring it even.
All right, there are the stats at halftime. Nothing in the penalties. They go New South Wales 3-2. The scrums, Queensland's way, the same margin. One try apiece, a goal apiece. There's no field goal. And, GD, that's about as close you can get, eh? Six each.
Well, the state of origin, you go last year, 2 points between the three matches. This year might be any different, but like I said earlier, Queensland are lucky that they're only 6 points all.
All right, we'll take a break and be back at the Sydney Football Stadium.
For the savings you make with Metway Bank's range of very competitive home loans, individually designed to be financially comfortable. For the support you receive from your Metway manager who will get you into your new home quickly and easily. For whatever reason, there is no other bank like Metway Bank. You've never had a better reason to change.
It's Mac time now for a big night out at McDonald's for just $2.
Must be the $2 dinner deal.
Big starter Maccas, please.
Every night after 5 p.m, the $2 dinner deal comes out. That's a cheeseburger, regular size serve of world-famous French fries and a small size Coke. That's McDonald's $2 dinner deal. Super value.
I love Maccas every night.
And we all love the nighttime value.
McDonald's $2 dinner deal.
That's value. It's Mac time now at McDonald's. Yeah.
The Falcon has always been a comfortable car, but now it's more comfortable than ever. With new seat fabrics, but more importantly, new levels of interior quiet. Quieter engine, improved sound insulation, and thicker glass. So you can listen in more comfort to the dynamic new four-speaker sound system. Have you driven the most comfortable Falcon ever?
Everything else is just hot air.
If you love your mum, you don't want to miss getting her a Mother's Day present. What if you went somewhere that didn't have a great range? What if you had to pay too much? What if it wasn't very well made? And what if it was the wrong size, wrong colour, wrong shape, and you couldn't take it back? No. If you really want to show your mum how much you love her this Mother's Day, come to Target. You can't miss.
2 4X light bitters.
You make a great hot curry, Remy.
You want to know the secret?
Mm-hmm.
It's chili filtered to lock in the flavour.
4X light bitter, the only light beer that's serious.
See a really funny movie and chances are it stars Tom Hanks and Meg Ryan.
You're so alive, I can see it.
Two of Hollywood's hottest stars.
Mr. Joe Banks?
He's into odd jobs.
I want to hire to jump into a volcano.
All right, I'll do it.
Untamed adventure and fiery passion.
I love you.
I love you too.
For the first time on television, an eruption of love and laughter.
Isn't this romantic?
Joe versus the Volcano, Sunday 8:30 on 9.
Sit back, relax, and enjoy a bitter 4X action.
So we're back here at the Sydney Football Stadium, waiting for the teams to come on for the second half of this match and the score at the half-time break. Queensland and New South Wales locked together at 6 points all. Well, there are a couple of replacements in the first half. Bradley Clyde went off, but the important one from Queensland, Gary Larson, went. We might have a look at this. It doesn't look too good from what we saw of it. Larson very sick when he took the field. There's Harrigan coming in over the top and bang. And Larson down. And that was the last we saw of him in the match.
Yes, and how did he move from that position? You see him in there until he was put on the stretcher and taken off. And, of course, three players of the 12 forwards that start, 25% of the board packs have gone because Bradley Clyde's off as well. Larson off. Steve Jackson was the first to go. He suffered concussion as well. So it really is... It's pretty tough stuff out there, and I believe the news from the dressing shed, not all that special with Bradley Clyde. It looks as if it could be a reasonably serious ankle injury on the Canberra lock, and he scored a try in that first half. The first try, surprisingly, of his State of Origin career, Bill.
Well, that surprises me a little bit, but he's been so prominent, hasn't he? But that just goes to show you, the blokes that do tend to shine a lot of times don't necessarily score the tries, but he's set a lot up, I can bet you that.
He has, and Paul McGregor, he's... perhaps been one of the best of the New South Wales players. A lot of talk about the rookies in this Blues side, and Paul McGregor was one, John Simon and Graham Mackay, three in the back line, and they've all performed creditably. Perhaps Paul McGregor the best. Any chance he's got, he's been very good. John Simon in, of course, for Ricky Stewart. We've got the Canberra halfback on the sideline with Sean Lawson.
Thanks, Andrew. Ricky, Phil would have been pretty pleased with the first 15 minutes, but after that, things started to go wrong.
Yeah, that's what Phil really concentrated on talking about. He said that he described Queensland as a sleeping giant. You can't lay off them for 30 seconds because they're the type of team that can score from anywhere on the field. And he was very upset with the way we finished in the first half. He thought that our last 5 to 10 minutes was very sloppy and that players were sort of falling off tackles and falling asleep. So he's, apart from that, he said that he wants the ball in their quarter as much as possible, because the team that has the ball in their quarter as much as possible, the team that has the ball in the opposing team's half as much as they can in the next half will win the game.
So what you're saying is put the boot to the ball and play to their half, eh?
That's right, yes, but you've got to make sure you get the chase team down there for defence.
How's Bradley Clyde?
Bradley's not too good. He's Doesn't look like coming back onto the next half. He's got a bad ankle injury.
The forwards, New South Wales forwards started on the ball, but they seemed to go off the ball for the second half of the first half.
They started very well, and when we got the ball wide, we looked very very sharp with McGregor and Fittler. Fittler's looked very dangerous two or three times he's got the ball. But as Phil described, the Queensland team is sleeping giants. Whenever we look good, you hear the crowd roar, and we saw the forward asleep, and then Queensland is straight back into our territory.
Your teammate, Laurie Daly, how's he at the moment?
Laurie's good, his knee's fine, and he's, as you can see, playing very well and leading very well.
What about the New South Wales backs? You boys seem to be going pretty well.
Yeah, very well. I think McGregor's going exceptionally well. He's defending well, and when he's had the chance with the ball, he's done the right thing, so he's going well.
What's the feeling like in the dressing room? Are they disappointed that they couldn't actually finish Queensland off? Looked pretty good for them in the first 20 minutes.
Not disappointed. A little bit dirty with themselves that they didn't finish strongly. They're still very confident. They're looking very well. There's an air of the atmosphere in there is of enthusiasm. And as I said, Phil's just really talking about these sleeping giants. You can't lay off Queensland at any stage of the game.
Thanks for your time, Rick.
Thank you.
So the New South Wales team have already made their way onto the field, and here's Queensland coming out now. Graham Lowe just to get one last little mention there, a little word going through to Dale Shearer. And Shearer, well, there are a few people doubted whether he'd be able to handle things tonight, but he's been pretty super cool out there, and even though he's had a fair bit of kicking coming his way, and I suggest you get a bit more.
He's done a bit of kicking himself, and I think that's one area Queensland can improve in the second half. It's been fairly well shared between Shearer and Langer, and none of them have really put pressure on the New South Wales team. The only one that did was a lucky bounce in the goal area, from which a few minutes later Queensland scored. So that'll be one place they'll look to improve on. Dale Shearer back at fullback will be wanting to find some ground. Not much wind down there as we look at the penalties. Three all. Everything's pretty even here. And the top tacklers, we'll look at Larson before he went off 15. And Benny Elias, he's been handy from the dummy half position, but he's also been doing his job in tackling. 24 of them.
Not a great deal in the tackles here either. 111 to 108. In the backs there.
Of course, Peter Jackson moved into the forwards when Larson was off, and he's made 11 tackles. Now, whether that remains in the second half, Jackson up front, we'll see in the next couple of minutes. Mal Meninga prepares to kick off.
And there he goes. As a matter of fact, as referee David Manson blows the whistle, they're underway for the second half of this State of Origin match. And 6 points all between these two sides, as New South Wales bring it up to about 20 metres out from their own line. The man to do it on this occasion is Harrigan. So back it goes this time to Mackay. So New South Wales with Elias trying to sneak away from dummy half, but Allan Langer's in up underneath him, and Gavin Allan in over the top. He's made the most of his opportunity tonight. So that's Gillespie. Elias swings it back to Laurie Daly. The kick downfield by the New South Wales captain. Dale Shearer back there to take it. He'll step his way up, out of the first tackle. Can't get away for the next one, though. It's put down by Cartwright, and also Mackay came about to take care of him. So to Meninga. Meninga brings it up to a couple of metres short of halfway. And three New South Wales players headed off by Harrigan and Lazarus and also Benny Elias. So this is Walters with it, gets it back to Jackson. Jackson outside to Linda. Linda to about 10 metres inside New South Wales territory. Then we have Walters to Langer, then to Walters to Mal Meninga. Meninga trying to power his way through but can't. Nicely wrapped up. So Walters to Langer. Swings it back to Shearer on the final tackle. He dummies to kick, now decides to have a run. Now he puts the kick in. It'll carry back down there to Andrew Eddinghausen. And so New South Wales have possession about 10 metres out from their own line. But Greg Darling's been down in the Queensland dressing room. What's the story down there, GD?
Yeah, Graham wants the Queensland kickers to kick longer instead of putting in little chips behind. And he also wants the kick chasers to get down there in one line and cut Eddinghausen off. Also, he wants more work out of his back rowers.
All right, what about Jackson and Larson? Will we see either of them again?
No, Larson, you won't see any further part of him during the game, but Jackson's back on the bench, so he could be coming back out.
All right, New South Wales with Benny Elias sending it outside to Cartwright. Final tackle now. Wait for Elias to swing it away. Back to Simon. Simon dodges away Kevin Walters. Now he's going to put his kick in, and he'll get it down into a couple of metres from touch and only 10 from the line. Dale Shearer decides to run it out, and he'll be put down about 20 metres out from his own line. So away from dummy half is Michael Hamilton. He's going to be grabbed and thrown to the ground. The tackler was Brad McCarr. So from the play, the ball, Gilmeister lost the ball in the tackle. Harrigan swoops it away, but Cartwright can't handle it. Eventually recovers for the referee to play the knock-on.
And that was as close to a dead-set four-pointer as you would have got if Cartwright had have been able to take that ball. An outstanding tackle from Daly on Trevor Gilmeister. Bang, popped that, Trev. Ball comes loose. Harrigan swoops on the ball. Cartwright's unable to take the pass. Queensland away from it.
Kevin Walters. Wrapped up by Mackay. So Meninga outside to Coyne. Coyne gets to the quarter line. Big Mal will be the dummy half again. He works the blind side. Goes himself, buffeting his way through. Bella was on the bustle inside, but he couldn't get the pass away. Coyne back to Jackson. Jackson tackled by Harrigan and also Lazarus. Dummy half is Steve Walters. Walters to Langer. Langer to, oh, it's going to be lost, but they regather. Willie Carr came away with it. But the referee said it carried forward.
He would have got more of a response from the crowd had it been Lang Park, because that was very much a line ball. And had play gone on, Queensland had a gap out wide, but Simon's feed to the scrum.
And New South Wales come away with it. Laurie Daly. Daly sending it outside then to McGregor, who's had a great first half for New South Wales. He's going to be tackled by Coyne. Dummy half Simon. Simon waiting for it and sends it back inside. This is Mackay. Tackled by Walters and Bella. 30 metres out from the Queensland line. Elias away from that dummy half posse. Dummies one way, then gets it away to Gillespie. Gillespie still going. Can't get his pass away, but he can. He gets it out the back. They're going to lose it. Rolls on the ground. Dived on by Daly. New South Wales retain possession. Dale Shearer coming in. Well, the crowd thinks he was a bit late and a bit rough. Cartwright with it. Sending it away to Daly. Daly tackle. He loses the ball back behind him. Regathers. Starts to run again, does Daly. Out of broken play, he might get something going. He does, he gets his pass to Ettinghausen. He in turn sends it outside, this time to Wishart. Wishart going to be grabbed and thrown to the ground by Michael Hancock. So New South Wales still with the pressure on, a couple of tackles up their sleeve. Running across field as Fittler breaks out of one tackle, looking for support. Finds Gillespie. Gillespie going to be put down. Here's the final tackle. What will they do? Elias waiting for it. Elias sends his pass back to Daly. Daly props back inside. Or Simon sent it back inside. Elias ended up with it. Dummy to kick. He kicked forward. But it's going to be the turnover.
Well, I tell you what, if I had two bob for every tackle Allan Lang has made 3 metres from the line, I'd be flying back to Brisbane first class. He really has been putting in the crunches right at pressure times for Queensland. Touch judge coming in to speak about tackle made by Mark Coyne.
Mark Coyne, he's pulled out. And we'll just wait to see what the outcome of this is.
Well, it's got to be a penalty to New South Wales. Whether or not he played someone without the ball, yes, perhaps that's it. Yes, his tackle play without the ball. Good decision and good work from the touch judge.
So the penalty goes to New South Wales.
Benny Elias coming off. Robbie McCormack's just gone on for New South Wales.
He's in jersey 17, McCormack. And Wishart kick one from the touchline to convert Bradley Clyde's try. He's going to have another attempt here. Well, Elias was tackled without the ball by Steve Walters, so I suppose it's take your pick. Can't give them two penalties, Slacky. Can you win him?
Well, I think if Wishart misses this one, they'd like another go, but they're not going to get it.
So Wishart about 23 metres out. He's about five in from touch. 7 minutes gone, second half, 6-6 the score. All the trainers on the field giving instructions and water. Wishart.
Looks like Gary Coyne's coming on for Queensland.
Gary Coyne in jersey 17.
We've got some smart mouth guards nowadays. The orange job for Rod Wishart. I've seen a few lime green jobs. I'm waiting for the purple polka dots. I might make a comeback. Rod Wishart, if he can get this kick, very important psychologically for New South Wales, but it is on the wrong side. He's a right footer around the corner style. It will be some kick if he can slot it. A very good conversion in that first half, which gave New South Wales their six. Rod Wishart from Illawarra.
No goal. And it's play on. Now, can Queensland get it out of there? No, they can't. Well, yes, they do. He wasn't effectively held.
Well, Peter Jackson's learned quickly in the forwards, working in the forwards, how to put that power on. That was an outstanding effort to get out of it because he was hit very hard when he first took it.
The New South Wales player down. In fact, the Queenslander's going in to help him.
It looks a bit like Laurie Daly.
I think it is Daly.
Well, that must have come from the collision.
It is him.
Well, there's Daly.
Yeah,
he might have
moved.
Got a knee. And hasn't moved. Now, they've already lost Bradley Clyde.
Gilmeister off for Queensland. Gary Coyne's gone on.
And that kick that hit the uprights almost went over the dead ball line. It must have been very, very close. Oh, Daly's no good at all. Oh. He wants to... I was talking to Azras about Daly, why he gets hurt so much. And you know what he told me? He said, Allan, he's such a competitor. He said he won't willingly ever concede. He said sometimes in rugby league, you've got to cut your losses. You can't break three or four tackles. You've got to go to the ground with the ball and wait your opportunity. He said his enthusiasm's so great, he wants to score at every opportunity and break every tackle. And he said that's the reason he gets hurt so much. As Salvatori comes on now. So these reserves are going to play a major part. I mean, in the build-up to the match, everyone talks about the starting 13, Andrew Slack, but it really is a 17-man game now, isn't it?
I'll tell you what, the starting 13 are diminishing rapidly from both sides, but getting back to that, Laurie, as Laurie Daly's put onto the stretcher, we'll take a break, be back in a second, 6-all.
Melbourne got rain and Sydney got yuppies. Tassie got the chop, but we got lucky. Nowhere does it like up here, does it? We love it up here. We don't just like it. We love it. We don't just like it. We love it. We love it up here. The people, the places, the mates, the faces, the forests, yeah. The beer up here. We love it up here.
Standing applause for Daly. He won't know about it. He might hear about it in the paper tomorrow. He's about to cross the sideline. The field is clear. Both New South Wales and Queensland attendants helping him. The sportsmanship prevailing. All right, Queensland in possession now. It's with Coyne. And the Canberra Warhorse takes it 5 metres short of the 22. 6-all the score. Something has to give. Which team will concede? That's great defence from New South Wales. And the Queensland player, Dale Shearer's down as Harrigan went in. Langer's run backwards, they've got him, and Fittler's dragged him another couple. There needs a couple of forwards to be there, and that's the changeover. Well, the kicking game's got a bit of a chink in it tonight for the Maroons. So that's gone loose by Salvatore's coughed it up on the first go.
Well, Allan Langer at that stage was looking for Dale Shearer, but you might remember Shearer was momentarily injured.
So Meninga. Into Lazarus. Well, Greg Dowling, what do you see so much? 9 minutes gone, second half.
Well, that could prove a psychological boost for Queensland. New South Wales losing their skipper and the player of the calibre of Laurie Daly. But with Salvatore coming on, it adds another running forward to the side.
All right, so Queensland play it outside their own quarter. Meninga.
Another interesting thing from the New South Wales point of view, Greg, they've got both their captain and vice-captain on the sideline. Benny Elias in, probably getting a couple of stitches. Daly off, I wonder who will be running the show.
Yeah, well, I'd say Jason, young Simon, would be calling a few shots, and maybe Cartwright.
Here's Mackay. Runs at Langer. Langer puts him down right on the chalk at the 22-metre. Salvatore hangs on to this one, and Lindner hangs on to him. Now McCormick goes to dummy half. Here's Cartwright. We haven't seen too much of his ball skills tonight, but he did say in pre-match interviews he'd be playing a bit tighter than he does at club level. Lazarus popped it out. He tried to pop it back to McCormick. Couldn't do so. 10 minutes gone, second half. 6-all the score. The first State of Origin match for 92. Gillespie. Now they're on the final tackle. Simon will have to hump. Shearer should just... Well, I thought he's going to have a go at that on the full. And I think when he has a think about it, he might have thought that was a better option, but the Blues chase is good.
I'm convinced that Queensland aren't putting enough pressure on John Simon on that fifth tackle. Steve Walters, time after time, is the only one putting any on Simon. Occasionally he's stepped in, but he's really got past him with some ease, and there's been nobody there as the backup. Consequently, he's got those good kicks away. Queensland keep getting pinned back in their own territory.
Well, McCormick doing a lot of work. just effected a nice tackle on Michael Hancock, and he's followed it up on Martin Bella. Coin over the advantage line. McCormick in again doing the tackling, but the pass is gone. So can Queensland get on a roll? Out the back to Kevin Walters, who dummies. Well, there's a fiddle in the play of the ball. Langer goes to ground. Now they're on the final tackle. Who's the kicker? Jackson. To split Mackay and Eddinghouse. A Wishart and Eddinghouse. And Wishart takes it. Can't beat the tackle of Kevin Walters. So we're starting to get into the nitty-gritty part of it now. One would think the first team to crack in the try department would probably lose the match. It's going to get down to that. Now Fittler gives it to Salvatore. He's tackled by Stephen Walters. McCormick goes to dummy half. Oh, gee, Harrigan, that pass was borderline. But over the advantage line he went. Simon, Cartwright. And now they're on the final attack. Khan drops back, so does Hancock. Shearer goes the blind side. Simon gets the kick in. That's down Shearer's throat. Salvatore's the chaser. So Michael Hancock takes it 10 outside the 22-metre line. Let's go to the sideline and catch up. What's the latest on the injury tab?
Steve Jackson with concussion. He's sitting on the bench, so he'll come back on. He's recovered from that. Gary Larson, well, he's got a bad bench. And as we said, he was bleeding from the ears, so he won't take any further part of the...
All right, so Queensland possession, and Harrigan midway, clan side of the ground. Elias looked like an old warhorse. That goes forward to Gillespie, so the pass is a shallow. And as the play gets on and the players get more tight, there'll be a lot more shallow passes. Salvatore runs it within 3 metres of the 22. All the players are stacked right-hand side of the field. But Cartwright goes on his own. Mackay, and Mackay's about 25 metres from him. Now they'll come right. Fittler into Jackson. Final tackle. Is it to the air or the ground? It's a field goal. This will be a rule, six to go. Salvatore steps to the 22-metre line. So the Blues have another go. They mount support. Elias runs short side. He's about 14 out from the line. Gillespie to dummy half, and Salvatore hits it up to Martin Bella and Willie Khan. They put him down 9 metres short of the try line. Now with Elias, Simon, Harrigan hits it hard. Can't pop the pass up. He's 10 out from the line. Simon. No, it goes to Cartwright. The ball skills to Fittler. Elias will run back to Simon. Eddinghausen. And he's eventually wrapped up and put to the ground by Meninga. Mackay, it's gone loose.
Should be Queensland.
And Hancock will come up with it. David Manson went over to have a good look. And Kevin Walters brings it away. 5 metres out from his own line.
There's been no knock forward. It's gone into the legs of Mackay and picked up by a Queensland player. Another good decision by Manson.
Now for the New South Wales injury toll. Here's Sean Lawson.
Yeah, it looks like a real battle of attrition down here. Bradley Clyde went off in the first half with an ankle. Benny Elias in the second half with a blood bin. And Laurie Daly, obviously, with another knee injury and probably a very good dose of concussion.
So Queensland take it outside the 22. They're spending a lot of territory down this end of the park. And reverses to Shearer. A lot of people thought they might have a weakness in the kicking game. That was probably the best one of the night from Shearer. To Mackay, can't beat the tackle of Meninga. Goes to dummy, takes it. Backs in front on. Wishart. Oh, I don't know whether Allan was onside. He wasn't marking up, but he wasn't back. He's got away with it. Now Elias for Gillespie. Centre of the ground. Elias. Who's he want? He's found McGregor. And he's wrapped up right on the halfway mark. Bobby Lindner taking a while to get off him. Elias to Simon and Cartwright. Now Fittler. Mackay and Khan, one-on-one. Doesn't have to be always.
Yeah, Peter, come on.
So Simon. Step.
Kevin Walters out on the wing. Can't beat the tackle of Salvatori. Territorially, it's been New South Wales the second half. And there's 17 minutes gone, 6-all the score. Queensland can't get out of their own territory. It's popped up and Walters was offside, and here's a set of 2 points. Oh, dearie me. Well, that's what happens when you can't get out of your own territory. Pressure brings error.
Yeah, well, Elias has been close to New South Wales' best player. He's really created in attack, and this defence shows what he can do in that area. Steve Waller's coming back, and I think he's probably taken the best option because Lazarus is right on hand, quick ball out right, and New South Wales had numbers. So perhaps Queensland had been staring at 6 points. At this stage, they're very much staring at 2. Kick from Wishart would make it 8-6 to New South Wales. There's 23 minutes and 18 seconds left in the match.
Come to think of it, that penalty, and I know you're going to give away 2 points, that might not be a bad option for Queensland because they're struggling down that end of the ground, Greg Dowling, and I think it was only be a matter of time before the Blues posted 4 or 6.
No, that's right, Allan. I think this is the stage where they miss Wally Lewis with his kicking game and his general on-field leadership. He keeps the side together, drives them forward. They're not doing that at the moment.
Well, New South Wales are doing exactly what their coach wanted them to do at halftime. Phil Gould said, play it down there in the quarter if you can, and they've just about done that to a tee.
Yeah, they certainly have, Billy. They've worked it back down. All the play's been in Queensland's half, you know, and all they're doing is just coming up with mistakes and just keeping the pressure on themselves.
So Rod Wishart, 10, 11 metres out. Elementary stuff for kickers of this fellow's capability. New South Wales lead 8 points to 6. We'll take a break and be back.
This is a beer that will not help you represent Queensland in a state of origin clash. It's not going to get you any closer to that girl you've been after for months. It's not going to make you a rodeo champion, thank goodness. And it's not going to make you a sun-bronzed Iron Man. It won't even make you rich and famous. It's not the secret of life. It's beer. Look, you drink it, you enjoy it. Get real. Have a Malt 75.
Back ready for the kickoff as Mal Meninga starts it up, and while they were coming back, bringing that ball back, Benny Elias was giving this team a nice old rev up. He wants to win this first one and get a flying start to the series for the year. But there's 21 and a quarter minutes remaining in this match here tonight. And New South Wales 2 points in front, 8-6. So now it's Elias coming up as dummy half as Harrigan slowly gets back to his feet. Across over there to Lazarus. Lazarus taken by Bella and also little Alfie Langer. Elias again. He looks for runners. And he finds Gillespie over there. So from the play, the ball. Lazarus again. Lazarus to some couple of metres short of the halfway. Final tackle. So we'll look for Simon. There he is. Coyne tried to harass him a little bit. The kick goes downfield. Michael Hancock will come away with it. Straightens it up. And is going to be put to the ground. Mackay coming in over the top. And underneath it was Salvatori.
Queensland back slowly.
So this is Mal Meninga working this ball. It's going to be knocked on over there by Linda. New South Wales come away with it. On it goes to Mackay. Mackay out of one tackle. Taken over there by Linda, who chased him. But New South Wales in a great position now to put some more pressure on. Back it comes to Lazarus. Charging his way up goes Lazarus. He'll be put down only about 4 metres out from the Queensland line. Elias to dummy half. Elias waits for it, sends it back the other way. Fittler, a long one coming on to Cartwright, tries to double around, he sent it a mile forward. Fittler will end up with it. No, Queensland come away with it.
Lucky to get out of that. By his own admission, I'm sure Mal Meninga wouldn't be terribly happy with his own game. He hasn't been able to make much of an impact, and that pass, which gave New South Wales the chance, really wasn't on. There was no point in it. They've been defending. They need ball security and to get out of their 22.
So it's Walters coming up as dummy half. New South Wales with an 8-6 lead. Back over to Allan Langer. He in turn gets it away to Walters. Walters outside of Meninga. Meninga almost finds a gap. Now he gets it away. It's going to be juggled by Hancock, but he's tackled into touch. Tackled into touch by Wishart. 12 metres short of the halfway mark.
And the hesitancy there again, because that pass just went fractionally behind Hancock. He had no room in which to manoeuvre then and was an easy target to be put over the sideline. Again, Queensland has to defend.
So the scrum feeder come up with the halfback and John Simon for New South Wales. Simon waiting to feed this scrum. 19 minutes remaining in the match. And the referee not too happy with things. Him by come out through his feet, Simon, and a bad pass going over there to Mackay. Mackay had to really go forward to get it.
Really, I think Queensland should be pleased if they look at the scoreboard down 8-6. The handling errors, they've made 9, New South Wales just the 4.
So it's New South Wales in possession now. Dummy half is Elias. Elias back over there to Harrigan. Harrigan up the centre. Can he get the pass away? He can. It goes back over there to Simon. Simon decides to have a run. They eventually pull him down. Walters getting in underneath and grabbing him by the jersey, and down he goes. Elias away from dummy half, turns it away to Simon. Simon going to be knocked over by Allan Langer, who's been in everything tonight. There's not enough of him out there at the moment. This is Fittler. Fittler running across field, slips out of one tackle, going for the break, but all crunching in comes big Mal Meninga and also Bella from the other side. They bottled him up, and New South Wales on the attack again. Simon with a little grubber kick, tries to take it on the toe. Got to be knocked on back there by Dale Sheeran. It's another 6 tackles. A big chance for the Blues now. Elias up to dummy half. Elias waiting for it. It's kicked through, I think, but it's going to be taken over there by Salvatori, reaching out for the line. He's in. Craig Salvatori is in, and New South Wales swoop to a lead of 12 points to 6.
Well, pressure equals points, and that's exactly what Craig Salvatori's picked up because of the pressure, which has been pretty well not fully existent from the second half from New South Wales down in the Queensland half. They could have gone left, and I think Queensland very keen to cover that over to their right side. They only had one defender there to take Salvatori. It was Gary Coyne. He wasn't enough that close to the line against a man of Salvatori's pace and power. He was easily able to barge through. It'll be 14-6, one would expect, after this kick. And that's a place from which Queensland may find it very difficult to come back, Greg Dowling.
Yes, it's a big ask to come back. This is going to make it 8 points difference. But Queensland are their own worst enemies at the moment. They're trying to, well, they're playing catch-up football. They're trying to run it from their own half, and they keep coming up with mistakes. And the forwards are very tired unit at the moment, and they just couldn't recover from it.
So now it's Wishart. There's the Queensland team in the in-goal area. And don't look too happy, and you can understand that. They're down by 6 points with a kick to come. And 16 and a half minutes remaining in the match. And they've been down in their own half of the field for most of this second half.
Brad Fittler's had a big impact out in the three quarters. The two of them have done very well. In fact, if anything, they've dominated the Queensland pairing, McGregor and Fittler.
So now it's Wishart attempting to convert the try. There's big Paul Sheeran and warms up on the sideline. Here's the kick coming in from Wishart. Should be another 2 points. And it is. Through they go. So New South Wales lead at the moment here at the Sydney Football Stadium is 14 points to 6.
I think this is pretty astute coaching from Phil Gould. You know, he had Surinan on in that first 25 minutes and really did create some havoc among the Queensland defence. He's been off ever since. There's about a quarter of an hour left. He's on the sideline ready to come back and give some of his best. And if it's like what he did in that first 20 minutes, Queensland might be in strife. Meninga kicks off.
Down to Graham McCoy. Martin Bella goes in and puts him down with the help of Gavin Allan. There is 15 and a half minutes remaining. 14 points to 6 is the lead for New South Wales. They've played all the match in Queensland territory and deserve their lead. Lazarus. They left Linda behind. And there's a quick play. The ball and the markers weren't there. And Wishart capitalised on it. He's over the halfway. And here come New South Wales storming back into Queensland territory. Harrigan. Tackled by Jackson, over the top, and in there was Walters. Now with Elias. Hancock. Oh, too good, New South Wales. The kick and chase. Hancock with nowhere to go. Langer over to Shearer. Runs into Lazarus and Salvatori. Gavin Allan. On the 22-metre line.
Queensland forwards one out and not coming from much depth.
Bella. So they're outside the 22 on tackle 4. Now Langer. Here's Jackson. Meninga's into a hole, but there's plenty of cover. He's got a forward pass. David Manson. Well, Simon had Meninga's measure and cover. Yeah, fair decision.
There was a good call, and that happened because the dummy runner of Kevin Walters just allowed the time for Meninga to creep a bit forward of that pass, and had it been passed straight away in front of Kevin Walters, would have been fine. By the time Walters was through and the pass went behind, well, Meninga was also through and in front of that advantage line. Good decision again, David Manson. Geez, he's done a good job with the whistle.
Paul Surinam coming on. Glenn Lazarus goes off.
So New South Wales with possession outside the Queensland 22 again. Here's Pittman. Quick play, the ball's required for the Blues, and they'll really nail it home now. Gillespie stands. McGregor. Strong game from this fellow tonight. Now Elias to dummy half, the 15 out from the try line. Elias, who are the runners inside? Harrigan, he's popped it up, and it's come into the hands of McGregor. They've had a bit of luck, New South Wales, with the bounce of the ball, but they should have it. They're the better team. They're playing the better football. Here's Cartwright. He takes it 8 metres short of the line. Simon calls for it, and Fittler's the first man outside him. He's got the football now. And now they put it down with Mackay. Bradley Mackay, that is.
And a little peek at Mark Coyne, Brad Mackay.
So Queensland have got to get down the other end. They have to score a try very, very quickly. And it's going to have to come against the run of play. So Langer now gives it to Khan. Wrapped up by Eddinghausen and Bradley Mackay. And now Coyne. Hit by by Gillespie and Cyril. Now Langer. Away to Linda. Who are the runners? They push the pass to Khan. Well, they're still pushing the ball, GD, in their own territory.
Yeah, New South Wales are doing it very tradesman-like at the moment. Of course, they're 8 points up, they should be. But Queensland have got to look to Alfie or this man with the ball, Jacko, to bring something out of the bag for them.
Well, at the moment, it's a little bag. Here's Langer, over to Shearer. Oh, he's wrapped up by cement. Dave Gillespie puts him to ground. Here comes Kevin Walters and throws it straight to the hands. He's got a penalty to Queensland here.
Very lucky to get away with that one. But, certainly there's plenty of football left with 11 minutes to go. And again, those pushed passes, there's just no point in. He's offside. Another good decision because one of the Mackays, Graham, just touched that pass from Walters, flicked it into Brad Mackay coming from an offside position. Queensland get their best chance of the half. They waited half an hour for it. Can they make use of it?
Well, it's gone backwards. Let's have a look and see what happens. They're just outside the 22. Now it's gone loose. Play on. Gavin Allen's tackle. They've gone back about 5 metres. Bradley Mackay, the tackler.
Doesn't seem to be much pattern. Very bunched, the Queensland attack.
So Coyne runs it straight. 5 metres outside the 22. Stephen Walters, the dummy half. And Langer's the first man left side. Well read by the New South Wales defence. So Bella to Shearer. Langer. Kevin Walters. Oh, well, this will be play on. How's the bounce? It's all right. Six to go. Peter Jackson, 10 out from the line. Now it goes through Langer. The wraparound to Kevin Walters. He runs it within about 8 metres of the try line. This is Queensland's best chance. Now it goes to Langer. Who's outside him? He's come back the other way to Stephen Walters. Jackson gives it inside to Mark Coyne, and Eddinghausen's got him in a ripper. So Queensland are still only a 10 out from the line. Peter Jackson, long pass to Kevin Walters.
Mal Meninga, where are you? That's who they need. Someone with the power of Mal Meninga.
Gavin Allan looking to run off Steve Walters, but the pass has gone to Coyne, and he's put it down, and Elias will come up with it. So New South Wales roll it on. They lead in the State of Origin opening decider 14 points to 6. Salvatori. Meninga hangs onto him, and with the help of Gavin Allan, he goes to ground. Sirenan. Cartwright. So they're using the big men, the Blues. They're midway between the 22 and the halfway, inside their own territory. But their kicking game's been good. Simon for Shearer. Sits up. Now he tries to give room, and they have numbers, but the defence, a cover, goes to Carr. He can't beat Graham McCoy.
Steve Renoff, the only man who hasn't been used in this game so far on the sideline, ready to come on and see if he can create some magic for Queensland, because they sure do need it.
Kevin Walters putting it down. Fittler coming away with it. He's got inside Meninga. And he takes it within 10 metres of the 22. He'll play it to Simon, and here's Salvatori on the bustle. New South Wales doing it in tradesman-like style. Sirenin hits it up. Met at the advantage line by the Queensland defence. So Salvatori has a quick play the ball, or Gillespie rather, to Simon. Now Fittler. What's McGregor do? I'll tell you what he does. He gives a nice pass to Wishart, and Wishart's only five out from the try line. There's a quick play the ball to Simon. Now they move it, the Blues. Here's Fittler. He's got it to Cartwright. He floats one over the top to Graham McKay, and he'll lose the ball as Khan pressures him into touch.
Pressure is what it was, and John Cartwright's played a very disciplined game today. He threw that long pass to Graham McKay, really had no option, but Cartwright hasn't tried to push the pass, he's just taken it up. He's done very well. There was the opportunity, used it well.
So it's Queensland, some 18 metres out from their own line. 7.5 minutes remaining in the match. The New South Wales lead is 14 points to 6. Gavin Allan with it now. Allan takes it up. The tackler will be Sirenin. Just looking at those wingers here, Andrew, they've had a great tussle tonight, I think. Really put it together, all of them. Peter Jackson looks for the ball. He was held back over there. Got to be a penalty.
Queensland have got to get there quickly and move the ball. There's 7 minutes left. They need to score if they're going to get back into this match. They're just wandering over there. The ball's on the ground. They're waiting. No urgency.
Allan Lang is going to find touch. And play will come up to about a metre short of halfway. So Greg Dowling on the touchline. 6.5 minutes remaining in the match. Can Queensland come back?
Well, 8 points is a big ask, but they've got to lift themselves more than what they're doing at the moment. They're just walking, as you can see. They're running one out. They've got to put a couple of short passes together and break this New South Wales defence up.
Well, a couple of kicks downfield before, and they're all in a heap waiting back there for someone to go up and follow that kick. But anyway, here they go now. That's Coyne. He's had a good save since he's been on. A little kick forward by Willie Carn. He's shouldered out over there. Coming through is Meninga. Oh, he almost took it from the halfback in Simon. They took the quarter peg. Now, what's the referee going to rule here?
Looking very anxiously at Graham Lowe, but you couldn't be further from the event than he was, right over the other side. Question is, yes, it's a goal line dropout.
Dropout from underneath the goal mount.
He's ruled.
But Coyne, he's broken the line on several occasions since he's been on there. Has looked very good.
Stephen Off is on, Bob Lidden is off.
And that'll be another rearrangement in the Queensland lineup. There's Benny Elias, who should be just about in the blood bin again, I would suggest. But there's no way in the world he's going to leave unless the referee tells him to go. With 5.5 minutes remaining, he can see a win in the State of Origin's first match under his belt right now. But there's the kickoff. Going to be taken back there by Shearer. Shearer decides to run his way through. Stepped out of the first tackle coming about from McKay. But he's going to be put down from the play of the ball. This is Martin Bella. Bella charging his way up. He's just on the quarter line. Dumbing half is Walters. Walters to Langer. Langer getting it away to Walters again. Outside of Peter Jackson. Centre back inside. This is Coyne. Or rather, Renoff in there now. Away it goes to Meninga. Meninga turns it back inside to Coyne. Coyne. Oh, gee, there's a big tackle coming in by Cartwright. Bang, how'd you like that one? Stevie Walters plays it. Allan Langer. Dummies. Going to be wrapped up by Elias right on that quarter line. He'll play at the dummy half is Walters. Back over there to Shearer into the action now. Shearer looking either way. Had Kevin Walters, but he've overrun the ball. Final tackle now. Dummy half Walters. Back it goes to Langer. Langer with a little chip kick through. New South Wales go for Ettinghausen. Lost it.
Meninga must have that ball. Certainly a knock on from Ettinghausen.
It was dived at by Mackay, but the referee's going to play the knock-on.
Martin Bella comes off. Trevor Gilmeister goes on for Queensland.
So the scrum to pack down about 8 metres out from the New South Wales line. Stevie Wallace urging his team on. New South Wales taking plenty of time to get across here to pack down the scrum. The New South Wales lead is 14 points to 6. Queensland ball, Kevi Walters sends it back inside. This is Dale Shearer. Shearer propping, running all around, slips over. Got to be Klein. He'll play it. Dummy half Walters. On to Gavin Allan. Allan trying to charge his way through. And he's held up. He's only a couple of metres out. Here's a chance for Queensland now. What can they do? Here's little Alfie. Got to be touched by New South Wales. Knocked down, towed through, picked up by Mackay. The referee running a knock-on.
Got to the stage where they really have to try anything now, Queensland, and New South Wales aware of that in defence and really creating pressure out wide and going for those intercepts. They know they've very largely got little to lose by doing it, and they've knocked down a couple of possibilities for Queensland. They have perhaps their last now, the Maroons.
Hanging to Walters. Walters outside to Shearer into the back line. He unloads it to Steve Renoff. Renoff got to be grabbed and thrown to the ground about 20 metres out from the New South Wales line, so they lost some territory on that occasion. Way from dummy half is Billy Khan. Dummy half waiting for it is Walters. Walters sending it back to Langer. Langer to Walters. Walters with a long one. Meninga can't pull it in. He toes it through, but it's going to be a knock on.
It has not been Mal Meninga's night.
No, the big fella has not had a happy time.
And you'd have got fair odds that the last 15 or 10 minutes of this game, you'd have seen Peter Jackson and Mal Meninga, supposedly one of Queensland's great advantages, packing down in the scrum. There they are, Meninga in the second row and Jackson at block.
So now it's going to be Simon to feed. 2.5 minutes remaining in the match. And New South Wales with a lead of 14 points to 6. And you'll hear this crowd at the end of this match. They'll let you know all about it. That's Glenn Lazarus back on the field for the final hurrah.
Salvatori off.
Salvatore's the man to leave the field. Elias in there as dummy half. On to Sirinen. Sirinen going to be wrapped up. Crowd starting to chant already. Elias, dummy half. He waits for it. Back it goes to Simon. Simon with a kick downfield. Over the head of Hancock. Running towards touch and is going to find it. Finding touch about 24 metres out from the Queensland line. Scrum to pack down from there. And 1.5 minutes remaining in the match.
Good long pass from Elias to give Simon that room. And Greg Dowling, it certainly has been Benny Elias's night. He's won the battle of the dummy halves and the hookers.
Yeah, he certainly has. Slacky, he's had a big game. He's been off in the blood bin. And he's cleaned up the rucks very well tonight.
So it's Queensland with Allan Langer in there as dummy half. They're going through the motions now. Trevor Gilmeister. Walters to Langer. Langer looking back inside. But there's no chance of finding any way through there as Kevin Walters was tackled well and truly. So Gavin Allan. Allan up to the halfway mark, trying to flick a pass back behind him. New South Wales will end up with possession. And we're into the final minute of the match. Cartwright getting up to play it on the halfway mark. Elias is a dummy half. He'll send it back over there to Lazarus. Turns his back on the defence. And eventually thrown to the ground, but he doesn't worry at this stage, the big fella. There's Laurie Daly. Good to see Daly has recovered. Bradley Clyde is the worry from the New South Wales point of view. Here we go now, trying to find a way through. Over there is Mackay. Put down 24 metres out from the Queensland line. Simon is the dummy half to Benny Elias. Elias tries to duck just one last time, but couldn't make it on this occasion. About to play it to Mackay. Mackay, the crowd starting to count it down. We're into the final 10 seconds of the match. New South Wales in possession. Coming up as dummy half is Cartwright, but it's all over. New South Wales have won the opening encounter here at the Sydney Football Stadium. They've taken the match out by 14 points to 6. Crowd goes wild. And why not? Good performance from their side tonight.
Yeah, better than good, Billy. I think it really was an outstanding performance considering the adversity they had to overcome. Obviously, Queensland did as well, but they lost two of their best players, perhaps their best players, Clyde and Daly. Very much the the big names in that New South Wales side and the experienced duo as well. But they didn't let that faze them. I think the presence of Benny Elias was a big help for that when he came back. He calmed the troops down. And there's John Cartwright, I mentioned just some minutes ago, a disciplined performance from him. He said before the match that he wasn't going to try and do too much throwing those fancy passes. It's just what he did. He did the hard yards. We've now got Greg Dowling down on the field.
Yes, with me now I've got Kevin Walters. Disappointing result tonight, Kevin. Where do you think this went wrong?
Well, mate, our kick game was probably a bit weak tonight, and I thought we couldn't get out of the kick in our own quarter for the majority of the game. You just can't do that in club football, let alone this sort of standard.
Yeah, that's right. Your kick chases weren't that good either tonight. Eddinghausen brought the ball back a long way.
Yeah, he did. Well, that's probably legacy, you know, not enough down the peg. But, you know, it's only that this is the first game, it's still two to go. So, you know, we played pretty ordinary tonight, but I'm sure we'll bounce back at Lane Park.
Yeah, thanks, Gabby.
Thanks, GD.
Yeah, I don't think there's any doubt they did play pretty ordinarily tonight, Kevin. Walters said Sean Lawson also down on the ground with Dale Shearer.
Thanks, Andrew. Dale, Queensland were their own worst enemies tonight by the looks of it.
Yeah, I suppose, especially at the end there where we tried to get some points back on the board. Spilled a bit of ball, but it seemed to happen in the second half and then cost us.
Yeah, their kicking game gets you pinned down there. Virtually you couldn't get out of your own half, could you?
No, I think it reverted back to... No, I think they were making good yardage when they were rucking it out from there, and we just couldn't contain them.
It seemed like Queensland was on the back step right from the start, early in the first 10 minutes or so, New South Wales on top, and then Queensland found it hard to get back in the game. They did, 6-all, but in the second half, you didn't really get a look in, did you?
No, as I said, you know, they had us backpedaling there in the second half. As was shown, there's plenty of room out wide, but unfortunately, we put the ball down a few times.
Well, two to go. Thanks very much, Dale. Crossing you, Greg.
Yeah, Lazo, a huge effort tonight.
Yeah, it was, mate. We had a long talk all week, and we decided if we went forward and got Johnny Simon got us down in their half, we knew we could come away with the match. And as you can see in the second half, we played a lot of football in their half.
Yeah, you did. The kicking game was great from Simon. He had a huge game. But yourself, your form was great tonight. You kept on taking it up.
Yeah, you know, I'm running in a bit of form now. I think all that training up with River makes me run in a bit of form. So, you know, hopefully I get chosen to play in the second one, and we can win that and take the series.
Yeah, the one up at Lang Park. Well, New South Wales don't fare too good up there, but it's good to get that first one under your belt.
Well, that's right. Yeah, that's something we're really put in the back of our minds. If we'd have lost this one, we knew we were going to be struggling to take the series up there at Lang Park. It's a pretty tall order, mate, so we're pretty happy to go up there 1-0 in front.
Thanks a lot, Glenn, and congratulations. And over to Sean with Eddinghausen.
Thanks so much, Greg. ET, fantastic effort by New South Wales tonight, but you had to work for it.
Yeah, it was a very hard game. We knew it would be a very tight game, and... you know, it's great to see the guys just keep hitting it forward all day, and a great kick and chase. I think that's what won it for us.
Yeah, but it looks a celebration. This means a lot to New South Wales tonight, doesn't it?
Oh, it certainly does. We had to win this one to get one up. It was no good going up there and trying to level the scores at one each, but we're very happy, and hopefully we'll go up there and win the series.
There was a lot of talk before the game about the rookies in your side, but they certainly came up trumps tonight, didn't they?
Yeah, they did. They all played great. Johnny Simon's kicking game was exceptional in the second half, and I think, you know, we just pinned them down there. Phil Gould said if we can just keep them down in their end of the field, we'll end up with the win, and that's what happened.
Congratulations. Over to you, Greg. Thanks.
Hey, John, another big effort from yourself tonight.
Yeah, very happy, mate. To come on, it's the first time I've ever started a game and beat you, Blake, so it was something I was really looking forward to.
Yes, you certainly played well, running out wide and linking up with the back line like a centre.
Yeah, you know, it wasn't really practiced that way because we had blokes like Bradley Clyde, Ricky, Laurie Daly to do that. But, you know, when we lost him, it was just a matter of, knuckle down and do your best.
Yeah, how much of an emphasis did that put on your game when you lost Bradley Clyde so early?
It really made a big difference because, you know, Bradley plays, but he gets back very early and does the early runs. And, you know, when he wasn't there, we all had to pitch in and do it.
Yeah, you certainly did that. It was a great effort by the forwards. You certainly took Queensland on in that area. Was that the match plan?
Yeah, mate, we had to play a yardage game. In years gone by, we've tried to get round them and use the brilliance out wide, but I think you've really got to try and turn them around before you can do that.
Well, congratulations once again, and thanks, John.
Thanks, Judy.
And back to Sean with John Simon.
Thanks once again, Greg. Johnny, you had to take a bit more responsibility in the second half there when Benny Elias and the half went off.
Yeah. I'm used to it down at Illawarra though, so you know, I just try to initiate the same things I do down home. Yeah, and the forwards responded, you know, they did their job, you know, and they're to be applauded for it.
You had a bit of help out there though. You said a few of the more experienced guys had a word to you.
Yeah, you're not wrong, yeah. Not just the experienced players, you know, Freddie Fittler, you know, Big Sal when he came on, he got us going, you know, forward all night. So same as Big
Five, camera five, checking camera five, camera five. Checking camera five.
to it.
Oh, you're not wrong. You know, the pace is just enormous. Now, I got a bit tired there in the first half, but, you know, the second half, you know, it slowed down a little and, you know, I got used to the pace.
OK, mate, well done.
Thanks a lot.
So there's a young fella who played the last two games of last year in reserve grade, and he's played State of Origin tonight. He's covered himself with glory. And what does Ricky Stewart do now? I suppose his experience has got to be there. But, gee, it's nice for New South Wales to know they've got a bloke like that, and they've got a couple of others finding form too.
Yeah, there's a bloke named Greg Alexander who's out at the moment, so there certainly are a few options. But I don't think Johnny Simon will be concerned about that at the moment. People said prior to the game, it's not just another game. John Simon learnt that today, but he also proved that it's not that he's not just another player. So a good performance from John Simon and all of the New South Wales team. We'll be back after this break.
Two more forex light bitters for you and your friend from Africa.
Africa?
Indian elephants have the smaller ears.
Cheers, big ears. Just joking.
I see there's 50% off Red Centre holidays.
Really?
7 nights in Alice Springs and Ayers Rock from $763.
They're not lounge around then.
We believe when you buy a new car, you should be getting more than just a car. You should be getting a serious commitment from the maker of that car. As part of our worldwide commitment to Nissan owners, every new Nissan will now be backed by the most comprehensive support program ever undertaken by a car company in this country. So if you own a new Nissan and happen to run into trouble, it's not just your problem. It's ours too. It's part of the new way we're going about business at Nissan. The new Nissan.
Tip-top multi-grains, yummy.
Yeah, it tastes just like white bread does.
How do they get the grainy bits so soft?
They hit them with a hammer, I expect.
No.
Mum, are they for us?
Tip-top multi-grain. White bread taste and the goodness of pre-softened grains. No wonder kids voted number one.
I reckon an elephant sits on them.
Just in time for Mother's Day, Errol Stewart's $6 million price blast. With dynamite deals like Simpson dryers blasted to $258, $100 off Volta cleaners at $199, Breville snack makers $29.95. Errol Stewart's $6 million price blast explodes tomorrow.
For the reward of a smart rate term deposit, with an interest rate that can rise but never fall below a preset minimum. For the reputation of Metway Bank's friendly staff who'll help you make some smart decisions of your own. For whatever reason, there is no other bank like Metway Bank. You've never had a better reason to change.
Monday night, see Meryl Streep as you've never seen her before. And America's comedy queen, Roseanne Barr.
What's going on between me and Mary is purely professional.
She-Devil.
Oh, my God!
It's champagne versus tuna casserole.
Slime ball.
As a bed-hopping husband gets all he wants and more.
You bastard!
And you get the nastiest good time in years when Toyota present the heaven-sent devil of a comedy, She-Devil, Monday on 9.
Welcome back to the Sydney Football Stadium. It certainly has been New South Wales night tonight. They've played well. And one fellow who really came up trumps as a debutante was Paul McGregor. He's with Darrell Eastlake.
Yeah, thanks, Rabs. Well, a fantastic game tonight. I mean, everybody was talking about the debutante players, but you guys just went out there and played it like you've done it four or five times.
Yeah, Phil made us very confident before the game, and the lead up to the game, all the boys helped us out, and everyone here was just great.
There were patches when we thought that everybody was getting so tired because New South Wales was bunched. I mean, could you see that from where you were?
Yeah, that's right. They were getting tired, losing Clyde and Daly, you know, the two outside men inside me. made it pretty difficult because they used it when they went off. The other boys were pushing in, helping the big blokes out, and left a big hole there. So when I come in, they had numbers, but as it worked out, we won. So that's the main thing about the game.
Mate, you've had a taste now. Is it the step up they all talk about, that we talk about, going up another cog?
Yeah, that's correct. But the crowd here just lifts you, and when you're tired, you don't feel tired because everyone's around so much, you know, and they just lifts you.
Thanks. Well done. Fantastic.
Thanks a lot.
Well, Peter Jackson, have you played in any tougher Origin games, Jacko?
Well, they're all tough, Paddy, you know that, mate. They're a bit tougher, I suppose, when you lose.
Where do you think you lost the game? Possibly the mistake area?
Yeah, just too many mistakes there on our end, and they just kept kicking it back. We were only up their end for that last probably 8 or 9 minutes, and, you know, full credit to them. There's no sour grapes with us.
How'd you handle the lock position? You had a couple of injuries, you had to go to the lock forward position?
Yeah, I didn't mind it, mate. You know, a lot more work in there, but, you know what? I thought I handled it all right, but I don't want to go there for it. It's not my... Look at your melon, mate. I don't want to be like that.
Well, Peter Jackson, very despondent, and so he should, and I think he summed it up pretty well. You're coughing up position and too much in your own territory, and that's just about the ball game. Anyway, we'll take a break and be back with more at the Sydney Football Stadium.
Can bank holdups be eliminated? Tomorrow, crime reporter Michael Lyons tells of a revolutionary high-tech security system that stops armed bank robbers, and now it's being trialled in Australia. Details in an iNews exclusive. Join us at 6.
2 4x light meters.
You make a great hot curry, Remy.
You want to know the secret?
Mm-hmm.
It's chili filtered to lock in the flavour.
4x light bitter, the only light beer that's serious.
The new Holden Commodore. How did we make substantial improvements on Australia's best-selling car? By offering independent rear suspension for a smoother, more confident driving experience. By making it safer, with better steering, better brakes, and a stronger body. Designed and built in Australia, with all the resources in the world. The new Holden Commodore V6. There's a world of difference.
If you love your mum, you don't want to miss getting her a Mother's Day present. What if you went somewhere that didn't have a great range? What if you had to pay too much? What if it wasn't very well made? And what if it was the wrong size, wrong colour, wrong shape, and you couldn't take it back? No, if you really want to show your mum how much you'd love her this Mother's Day, come to Target. You can't miss.
You've got the whole world in your hands, with MasterCard in your hands.
You've got the whole world in your hands, with MasterCard at your command. You've got the whole world in your hands, with MasterCard.
No card opens more doors in more places than MasterCard. You only need one card. MasterCard.
At BP, we like to think our new service stations are the best in the world. Which is why our special fact-finding team is constantly checking, as unobtrusively as possible, how well our stations are maintaining the standard. Thank you. We're pleased to say the results have been very encouraging. But why not come and check us out for yourselves? BP, on the move.
No other Australian family car comes even remotely close to the convenience and security of Holden Commodore's standard anti-theft system. That's just one of many reasons it's Australia's top-selling car. Holden Commodore, there really is a world of difference.
Imagine shopping where things are always on special.
Motor car, furniture items, it goes on and on.
It's no daydream. Tomorrow we'll show you how to save thousands. Also, local boy made good James Blundell on Brisbane Extra.
Well, welcome back to the Sydney Football Stadium. Andrew, I suppose in those interviews we've heard, I mean, the common denominator, drop ball.
Yeah, mistake rate was one of the things used, I think, and certainly that's the case. But I felt it came back. Obviously, anyone who makes the greater mistakes is going to lose the game generally, but just no pressure on John Simon. He did kick well, but it wasn't put on. And the thing that surprised me was while that didn't happen early, that it didn't change, and somebody caught on to it and said, listen, let's put some pressure on this character. But it never eventuated. But I think you've got to pay great credit to Phil Gould. He's proven the bloke's only 34. He's won two premierships with different clubs, been in three grand finals. First state of origin appearance, they have a win and a well-coached one. They looked as if they knew what they were doing most of the time. Take away the last quarter of an hour of the first half, they lost their way a bit.
Yeah, very methodical.
Oh, indeed, very methodical. And that, I think, is due credit to the young guys. I think it's very important that you have a good start if you're a newcomer to this, and that's what all those guys did. And the loss of Clyde and Daly didn't matter. They then went on and played very well.
Yeah. All right. I don't think you people at home get too many mitties if you work out who the man of the match is. He looked like he'd just come from Custer's last stand. Here he is with Darrell Eastlake.
Man of the match, voted by the footballing press, the written press, and Benny, all I can say is congratulations on a magnificent effort from you tonight.
Yeah, thank you very much, Darrell, but I want to thank all the players and Gus Gould for a tremendous effort. They really, you know, stuck to a very simple game plan, and, you know, it was a matter of discipline out there, and, you know, those guys, you know, what can you say?
6-6 at half-time, what was said?
Well, you know, keep our cool, you know. I mean, we had their number. I mean, we started off with a lot better start than they did, and we had the strength up the middle. We were making better yards than they were. A good kick and chase game in the second half and just maintain our discipline down there, and that's what was called, and that's what was responded.
The side looked incredibly tired halfway through the first half and into the second half.
Well, I hope you can forgive that, Darrell. It was played at a hectic pace, you know. It really was, and I think both sides were just, you know, legless after about 30 minutes because it was like two complete full games of Winfield Cup, and, you know, it was just that 10% extra that he asked for the second half, and, mate, I think the guys gave 15.
Benny, the courage is never doubted. I mean, the injury toll is testimony to that.
No, that's right. You know, I mean, there was a lot of criticism about the five new players to the side. I mean, if anything, that gave us a lot more enthusiasm. I mean, they were like kids in a lolly shop, and, you know, they really just generated that to the experienced players. I felt like it was my very first state of origin game. I was nervous right throughout the whole week, and, you know, just rubbed off on all the players and right through management and coach.
I thought a turning point there. You took control when Laurie Daly went off, and you really started roaring at the players, and you started to use the football inside their 22.
Well, I mean, at 6-6, there was to be a turning point. I mean, it was either one side or the other side to take the initiative, and, you know, we wanted to be that side, and we had the ammunition, and I thought we just took it to them.
Little big man tonight, Benny Elias. Congratulations on behalf of Winfield. $1,000 man of the match.
Thank you very much, Darrell, and thanks to all the guys.
Do you ever look like that after you won?
Certainly not. Look a bit like lipstick, some of that as well, I think.
Call for the makeup girl immediately. All right, let's go to Sean Lawson, and with him is the Queensland coach, Graeme Lowe.
Thanks, Allan. Wasn't a real good performance in the second half from Queensland.
Oh, I wouldn't be so severe as to say that. I think we made a couple of mistakes that put us under pressure. But there was plenty of effort in there, and we were still in the game right to the dying stages. Just the number of things went against us, that's all.
Early disruptions, a few injuries to the forwards, that didn't help.
No, we got lost two players, you know, early on in the game, and that, you know, we had to have a bit of a reshuffle, but that's what it's all about. We still handled that, even though we had to reshuffle the players. We still handled it, I felt, and you know, we were still playing well.
That's right. New South Wales were on top of the first 10 minutes, but then Queensland virtually controlled the next 30 of the first half. I suppose you would have expected more from this side in the second half.
Oh, no, you know, you're playing up against a good side, New South Wales. We knew we were going okay at half time, and there wasn't much in it at all, and it was just going to be probably just a couple of little tiny things that won or lost us the game. And as it turned out, just, you know, possibly the penalty that they got to put them a couple of points clear, that was just one of those jammy things that happens, and you know, you can't plan it. It's hard to stop that sort of thing happening, and that probably turned it their way.
Still two to go, though.
Oh yeah, you know. We're not shot birds, don't worry about that. There's plenty of spirit and plenty of heart and in the performance, and I think that we have got a lot to look forward to.
We agree. All the best, mate. Thanks.
Thank you.
Well, Andrew, Graeme is talking about the mistakes, but when a team is making so much pressure, the mistakes come. and the bounce of the ball always seems to go the way of the attacking team. There was a couple of times it was kicked through, charged down, New South Wales, six to go, the bounce of the ball comes up in your lap. But you expect that when you're going well, don't you?
Yeah, well, the word's pressure. Pressure turns into points eventually, and if you keep putting it on, it'll seem that the bounce is coming your way, whereas, in fact, you're creating that bounce. But the thing that's curious for me is that Don Ferner, chairman of selectors for the New South Wales, said there would be changes win or lose. That's been a tough old reward after that game, isn't it?
Don't want to change Benny Elias. He'd be a bit dirty after looking like that. Anyway, we'll take a break and be back with more.
The ultimate getaway package. A fascinating premiere special, 7:30 Thursday on Channel 9.
And welcome back to the Sydney Football Stadium. Andrew, I suppose it's time to reflect on the match, and the first half had just started at a crackerjack pace as per usual.
Yeah, and as I mentioned before, it was important, crucial in fact, for those new players in the New South Wales team, the youngsters, to get a good start. That's exactly what they did. Let's take a look at the first half highlights.
Now Elias. Simon to Sirenin standing wide, trying to put Fittler into a hole. Now, have they got numbers? Queensland's cover's coming. Here's Daly. He's settling the inside for McGregor. Now runs inside and out, and Clyde's beside him. McGregor's still going. He takes it within 10 metres of the line. Clyde was looming on his outside. Elias the dummy half through Simon Eddinghausen. What's he do? He finds a hole. He's hit a bit high by Shearer. He takes the tackle. They're on number six. What do? Do they go to the air or do they grub it? They throw it. And Mackay. Well, has that gone forward? It's play on. And Harrigan goes to ground. And that will be the first changeover of the match.
Dummy half will be Elias. The pressure's really on now from New South Wales. They've really started far better than Queensland, I feel, at the moment. Elias doubles around. Now he gets a pass away to Clyde. Clyde going for the corner. He's going to score. The first try of the match for New South Wales. Bradley Clyde is over after only 8 minutes of play. Rod Wishart looking for the extra 2 points. It's looking all right. It's coming around well. It's got to be there. That's a great goal. That's a terrific kick. And it's 6 points to nil. From the play of the ball. Jackson sending it back to Langer. Langer holding back the pass, going to do all sorts of things. Runs across field. Fittler gets a hold of him. He gets away to Gavin Allen. Back inside to Shearer. Shearer runs around. This is Meninga. Meninga, he gets his pass outside. In the corner. No. In a touch. In a touch it was. Bobby Lindner going for the corner. But in a touch.
No, he shifts it, and they have numbers out wide. Allan decides to take the tackle back to Langer. That'll be 4 points. They've got it back. Gavin Allan, I thought momentarily he'd done the wrong thing. The numbers were left. He stood on the tackle. Allan Langer backing up beside the post, and after the kick, this should make it 6 points apiece. That's a level ball game. It's 6-6.
What do you think at 6-6 at halftime?
Well, I thought Queensland had dominated the last 15 minutes, and if they could carry on, and as we've said more than once in this telecast, improve their kicking game, improve their pressure, that in fact they would have come away as winners. I don't think that happened, but you can take a look for yourself. Let's have a look at the second half highlights.
Cartwright with it, sending it away to Daly. Daly tackle, he loses the ball back behind him, regathers, starts to run again, does Daly. Out of broken play, he might get something going. He does, he gets his pass to Eddinghausen. He in turn sends it outside, this time to Wishart. Wishart going to be grabbed and thrown to the ground by Michael Hancock. So New South Wales still with the pressure on, a couple of tackles up their sleeve. Running across field as Fittler breaks out of one tackle, looking for support. Finds Gillespie. Gillespie going to be put down. Here's the final tackle. What will they do? Elias waiting for it. Elias sends his pass back to Daly. Daly props back inside. Or Simon sent it back inside. Elias ended up with it. Dummy to kick. He kicked forward. But it's going to be the turnover.
Well, it's got to be a penalty to New South Wales. Whether or not he played someone without the ball, yes, perhaps that's it. Yeah, he's a tackle player without the ball. Good decision and good work from the touch judge.
Kicking back, hits the post, no goal. Simon, no, it goes the other side to Cartwright. The ball skills to Fittler. Elias will run back to Simon, Eddinghausen, and he's eventually wrapped up and put to the ground by Meninga. Mackay. Mackay, it's gone loose.
Should be Queensland ball.
Can't beat the tackle of Salvatori. Territorially, it's been New South Wales the second half. And there's 17 minutes gone, 6 all the score. Queensland can't get out of their own territory. It's popped up and Walters was offside, and here's a set of 2 points. Oh, dearie me. New South Wales lead 8 points to 6.
Big Mal Meninga and also Bella from the other side. They bottled him up, but New South Wales on the attack again. Simon with a little grubber kick, tries to take it on the toe. Got to be knocked on back there by Dale Sheeran. Another 6 tackles. A big chance for the Blues now. Elias up to dummy half. Elias waiting for it. It's kicked through, I think, but it's going to be taken over there by Salvatori. Reaching out for the line. He's in. Craig Salvatori is in, and New South Wales swoop to a lead of 12 points to 6. Here's the kick coming in from Wishart. Should be another 2 points. And it is. Through they go. So New South Wales lead at the moment here at the Sydney Football Stadium is 14 points to 6.
There's a quick play the ball to Simon. Now they move it, the Blues. Here's Fittler. He's got it to Cartwright. He flakes one over the top to Graham Mackay. And he'll lose the ball as Khan presses him into touch.
Well, there it is. Scoreline of 14 to 6. Just have a look at the stats. The penalties went the way New South Wales 5 to 4. There was nothing in the scrums. Two tries to one and the two to New South Wales. I don't think Queensland got an excuse. You think they'll make any changes, Andrew, or will they stick with this lot?
Oh, no, I think they have to. They've got to find a kicker somewhere.
Yeah.
And the other crucial factor there, not in the stats, is the amount of dropped ball. And Queensland certainly dropped a heck of a lot more ball than New South Wales. The mistakes were made. New South Wales capitalised. And I think Graham Lowe, although he wasn't too critical of his team, understandable enough, I think he will look to make the odd change.
All right, so that's State of Origin 1 down. But there's a host of football coming your way on Nine's Wide World of Sports. Just a reminder of the matches coming up. Friday, round 7. That's a full replay Friday night. That's from the Wacker. That'll be a beauty over in Perth. That's Parramatta playing Canterbury Bankstown. That's a full replay Friday night at 8:30. And, of course, on Sunday, we'll be doing the Broncos-Illawarra match. Now, you'll see highlights from that on 9 from 5 to 5. So that'll be a great match, Illawarra Broncos. And, of course, the match of the day on Sunday in round 7, the highlights at 6:30. That's between North Sydney and Balmain. And, of course, game 2, State of Origin from Lang Park on the 20th of May for Queensland to try and square the ledger. Well, that takes us away from the Sydney Football Stadium. I'd like to thank Billy J. Smith, Sean Lawson, Greg Dowling, and, of course, you, Andrew Slack. On behalf of all the crew here, it's good night from the Sydney Football Stadium.
Has been another presentation from Nine's Wide World of Sports.
State of Origin, there's nothing like it, is there? Tomorrow, Chris Bombalis will have a complete wrap of our exclusive coverage. We'll relive the high points, look at where the game was won and lost, and go into the dressing room for player reaction. That's 9.